Should have caught up with stream by now. Right, let me find blades. Bladders.
Someone said can bury sub in.
Oh my god.
If only.
If only he would.
Every time my doorbell rings, I'm like,
Barry?
Is that you?
Could it be?
Is there a link for the game as well?
Yes.
I'm joining in now.
Give me a moment.
That was a fun first game. It's going well so far.
Good.
Let's get our Twitters on, boys.
Oh, yeah. Activate social media.
Activate social media, hype engine, yes.
Yes, I have had some caffeine, and I am ready to be a creative and inspiring individual.
Nice.
Live on the internet.
I'm working on that.
We'll get there.
It'll take a minute.
There we go, Blades and Dog.
Counter roll play. And you should come watch Blades in the Dark.
So I'm probably going to need a little bit of hand holding, guys, just because Blades in the Dark is new to me. But
That's fine, don't worry. It's very much.
Like, full-on piggybacking. I have no idea what's going on.
Yeah, so don't worry. I already run this game like every... literally I've run a session every month, so even as a GM, I'm relatively new to it. But don't worry. We kind of hand-wave a lot of the weirder rules.
Yeah, I have no idea what I'm doing, so...
I know. Will's... I don't think Will's ever bothered. Even though he's played as much of this game as I have, and... yeah, has no idea what he's doing. It's great.
Yeah.
He just occasionally just goes, yo, can I just... throw lightning bolts at this dude? I'm like, well, I mean, sure.
Oh my, have you guys ever seen that video of those people like
lightning
out
bolt
in the woods?
Lightning bolt! Yep.
It's more or less Carro, to be honest.
Yeah, that's
So the idea of this game is that you make up a gang of thieves who are stealing from whoever the fuck is vulnerable to give to yourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And you pick the characters from that little list, and you form a little crew, and you go off and commit crime. And this sort of... so if you've ever played the game Dishonored, that's the kind of the world it's in. It's all... Or Thief, for instance, if you've seen either of those two. Like, kind of Victorian aesthetic, but lots of electricity.
It's English, Sydney. You might not know.
You might not have heard of it.
The way I was thinking was electropunk. There's no like magic. There's no crazy wizards, but there are like
electropunk's my new band.
Yeah. But
it's got Lars in it.
Fucking hell. But there are like ghosts and demons and people who can use that tap into that kind of belief as well.
That's just a place.
Electricity in this world isn't made from oil. It's made from Leviathan blood, which is essentially so. Imagine a whale. Make it bigger. And make it a demon, and people go out on ships and hunt them, and then take their blood and bring it back and mix it with ghost residue, and that makes electricity.
Is there like a fantasy Greenpeace trying to stop people from killing the whales?
Not really. I mean, like, it's hard, I think, to get to that level of morality when they literally live in an ocean of like black ink that has a different set of stars at the bottom. It's so ungodly and horrible. And yeah. There are just other demons trying to stop you doing it because, you know, they have self-preservation skills. And then also there's people like Will's character, Carro, who's just suicidal. the thing about this game is that it's less about just straight up hitting people and more about, like, you have a lot of ways of dealing with situations, including hitting people.
Right.
And you don't have HP. Instead, you as players have one advantage over NPCs, basically. And that is that you guys can get stressed. That's your key advantage. You can use stress to try and improve your chances. You can use stress to try and, like, resist dangerous consequences. So I can go, yeah, he stabs you in the face, and you can go, I roll stress resistance. And just ignore the fact. We'll get into all that. But yes. So we start in the city of Duskwall. In the Eternal Empire, something like that? I forget exactly what the...
Carro's Eternal Empire, something like that, yeah.
Yeah, totally. You're definitely that influential.
Yeah.
Yes, the Imperium underneath the Immortal Emperor, city of Duskwall. So yeah, you this like kind of gothic Victorian looking city surrounded by sparking electro towers that keep ghosts out, and is generally, and oh, is constantly dark.
Yeah.
This world is net. There's no such. The sun isn't really a thing.
Like my soul.
It kind of gets like you get sort of like noon, not noon. You get like dusk is like the brightest it gets.
Yeah.
And then most of the time it's just pitch black.
All right.
So yeah, that's the world. Shall we, to give people an idea of the kind of characters you whip up? Do you want to reintroduce Carro to everyone, Will?
I do. Yeah. Give me one sec. Okay.
I will find your stats while you talk.
Yeah, because I have no idea. I know. So, Carro is a former noble, formerly of the elite, but he fell into disrepute for a number of reasons. He has a big gambling problem, in a big way. At first, that was just gambling with money, and now it's gambling with his life and the lives of others. And so it leads him into ever more dangerous situations. He possibly has a problem with self-harm because he keeps lightning storming himself, which is pretty painful, it would seem like. Every situation in which he creates lightning storms ends up nearly killing him. But he's a nice guy, really.
Yeah, you know.
I mean, he's fairly dislikable, I guess, but in a bumbling sort of way.
He's just a fat, weird dude.
Pretty much,
you know?
Yeah.
It's adorable. Yeah. He might accidentally summon a Titanic demon thing to the edge of a town and go, lol, this
yeah,
should be funny.
That's happened.
Yeah. That reminds me of Brandon.
Yes. yeah, and your skills... Oh, yeah, you also had a relatively public dispute with an proper noble family known as the Skurlock. Specifically, they're kind of family head who you accused of being a vampire. You were right.
Oh yeah, it definitely was.
You just didn't necessarily win the battle for people's souls. And you could also order ghosts and demons to do what you want and make lightning and ice and all sorts of things with your mind.
All the day's work.
Yeah, it's all good stuff. Yes, so if we hop to page 30 on the PDF, you two, we shall whip up some characters very quickly. So yes, the first step, who wants to go first?
Sydney does.
Sydney, yeah, take me
on. Don't worry, I'm here to help you through this.
I want to go first.
You'll be fine, trust me.
I can go first if you really want, Sydney.
No, it's fine.
Okay, so, first of all, you've got to choose a playbook. You have the cutter, who, they carry a big stick, and they walk tall. You have the hound, who is a crack shot and a good tracker, and also can have a dog. You have the leech.
Oh, that one.
Well, I say a dog. It can actually be almost any trained hunting pet. I'll just go through the rest of them because Gareth will pick as well. There's the leech, who's kind of... you have a bit of like witch doctory kind of stuff. You can make poisons. You're a saboteur and a tinker, so you can make bombs, poisons. You can also do things where you've ingested so much poison that you can now spit or exude it at will. We've had that before. That was quite fun. The lurk is the classic super sneaky. I can sneak into a place without anyone seeing me and sneak out again having taken all their stuff. The slide is the kind of the bard character. You're a spy. You're really good at talking to people. You also have a cane sword by default, which is kind of awesome, which actually Carro is carrying one of these around from an old friend of his. But yes, and a bunch of like loaded dice and all that kind of jazz. You're a manipulator and social kind of person. And then the Whisper, who is the ghostly weirdo. So those are the options. So what would you like to go for?
The dog.
Are we sold on the dog?
Yes.
Okay, so the hound. So yes, the first thing we do is, first thing that I do is I start taking notes. So I actually have all this to hand later. So, Sydney. Dang.
We got some background music for this going.
I mean, you're the one running production. You've got like 20 minutes while I'm just dicking about.
I like it.
I believe in you. yes, so we'll get to... So start thinking, by the way, of names and all that jazz, although I'm sure you'll come up with something weird. No. So first of all, you need... I know. The first time I met you, you did come up and say, "Yo, do you want to have real crazy magical powers? You can worship the spaghetti demon." And I was like, "Well, okay, I guess we're going to do like this, is it?" So yes, you get to pick a special ability from this hound playbook. So if you look in the grey box on page 32, you'll see the assorted things you can choose from, which includes you can give your dog ghost powers. You can be really predatory.
Ghost dog.
You can be really good with like a sniper rifle.
Can the dog be Scooby Doo, please?
No.
Because then I could be Shaggy.
Reggie?
Reggie?
The armor stuff is your ability to kind of just go, I negate certain sorts of bad things happening to you. So if I go, yo, a ghost makes you terrified, and you go, nope! I have cold precision. Yeah. So what takes your fancy?
Just pick any, pretty much, is what I did.
Okay, well, maybe I want to do things differently.
you do that. I'm gonna eat my sandwich.
you enjoy that sandwich, fella.
I will.
I want this ghost hunter thingy.
You want to be okay? So your hunting pet is imbued with spirit energy, gains potency when tracking a pet, it's natural, and gains arcane ability. So you want ghost form? Do you want to build? So that's it, can turn into a ghost. Mind link, which I presume is your ability to kind of see through its eyes, and I have no idea what Arrow Swift is, so don't pick that.
Not that. I want the mind link.
Okay. So we have ghost dog.
Ghost dog. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na, ghost dog.
Mind link. Fantastic.
Okay. Hello there, puppy.
So if you look over just to the right of the grey box, that all the Oh, first thing. So in the grey box, there's the item section. And then there's some other items over to the right. So you've got the fine pair of pistols, the fine long rifle, all that jazz. And then there's a blade or two, throwing knives. These are all things you own by default and have back at your house. But like, you don't bring everything with you into the field, usually. You're kind of limited by having 6 boxes checked. So that's it. Like, you, and when you do that, you look like you're loaded for bear. So just kind of keep that in mind of like how much stuff you can feasibly carry. But I don't really bother to try that too much because it's a pain in the ass. Whenever you see anything like electroplasmic, by the way, that's can interface with ghosts or lightning shit.
Nice.
So electroplasmic ammunition works as well on ghosts as it does on people. Just on people, there's a lot more burning and screaming and giant electric bolts in their chest. Cool.
Beautiful.
Yes, and then above that, you will see, just on the right-hand top right corner, there's these assorted insight, prowess, resolve, and underneath 4 different things each. Those are the skills in the game. You start with 2 points in hunt and 1 point in survey. And we're about to give you a bunch more. I'm going to skip the heritage stuff because it just takes time. So I have a question. So what did your character do before they were, I don't know, a thief? There's a bunch of backgrounds suggested. So academic, labor, law, trade, military, noble, and underworld. You can obviously get a little more specific, but those are kind of general areas.
Can I be a dog trainer?
Who did you train dogs for?
A lord.
What were they doing? Were they like, did you train dogs. Sniffer dogs for the police, or did you train like dogs to fight in underground pits?
Oh, not that one, for the police.
Okay, so you used to train sniffer dogs for the blue coats.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, so you worked, I guess, in law. So yeah, you get to a.
It's not cocaine, officer.
Okay,
it's
so
just flour.
2 skills you want to bump up as a result of your past as a dog breeder.
From any of these categories?
Yeah, so the only thing is that you're not allowed to raise anything past 2 dots. So you couldn't put any more hunt in. I mean, okay. You might have just 2 points of sway because you're really good at convincing dogs. Or maybe it's more 2 points of command because you yell at the dogs so they do what you want.
I was gonna say command.
Okay. That's entirely fine with me. Okay, just let me start making a note of things.
That's not allowed, I'm afraid.
Outrageous, I know.
Not on this stream, goddammit.
I have to command you to stop.
That's good. You've got extra points in there. You can't stop Heavenbar.
I just can't do it. And then you get to assign two other points for stuff you're just kind of good at. So, to anything. So the command comes from you've spent a long time yelling at dogs, and these other two are just like, stuff you're just kind of okay at. You kind of convincing? Are you decent in a fight? Do you know how to, like, build a grenade from scratch?
I can.
Or are you good at sneaking around?
Oh, it's sneaking around. That one's better.
Okay, so that's prowl. Do you want to... You can put, like, one in that and then one in something else, or do you want to put both in that? There are... By the way, on the main character creation page again, under actions, all of these have, like, what they kind of do. So, if you want to ask me, because I've messed around with them all a bit, I think you can feel free to ask, but...
Let's put one there and one in wreck.
In wreck. Okay. Wreck is always a fun one.
Wreck?
Yep.
Yeah, so... Wreck, a place or obstacle with savage force or carefully applied sabotage. Breach defenses with force, create distractions and chaos. The capacity to fuck some shit up. Yeah. Cool. Don't do too much with the item stuff because it just, again, it takes time. And as long as I don't take the piss, I won't get mad. I don't get mad. Don't
play.
So,
the snaps. He just goes. He's on such
come at you. Right, so the thing we want to pick is we have to know what your character's vice is. What is the thing they do when they want to chill out? And by chill out, I do mean go binge drinking. They've redone them. Oh, the ones now are faith, gambling, luxury, obligation, pleasure, stupor, or weird. Excuse me.
My vice is Miami.
Hey. yeah, so this is when you want to, like, after jobs, when you've got money from your assorted heists, what do you spend it doing? Do you just go to the church and pray the sin away and throw massive amounts of money in the collection pit? Or do you, like, nah, mate, and just, like, go to the fanciest, like, you sit in the Ritz just having tea for, like, 4 days straight, and then go, oh, I'm out of money, it's time to go back and make some more. Pleasure, kind of does what it says on the tin, as is gambling. Obligation always seems to me is, like, you just kind of, you accumulate debt because you're an idiot. I'm never entirely sure what obligation is supposed to be. they have expanded the stress stuff.
Finbear wet.
I'm waiting for now the Photoshop picture of just a grizzly bear with my face on it. Get on it, stream.
It's coming.
So yeah, what does your character do when she, or he, I don't know yet, wants to cool down and chill out?
Binge drinking.
Binge drinking. I think that goes under stupor, I would say. Okay, that's, your vice is...
That's my girl.
Stupor, and I just will set up the counter for your stress there. Yes, so bear in mind you get 8 stress before you pass out, essentially.
Gotcha.
So, you know, you can use it to buff up rolls and stuff. And then after the jobs you drink like a maniac and you get rid of your stress, is the way this game works. But we don't obviously get too much into that because I never have more than one character who's the same. Alright. Last thing is the name and possible alias and look of your person. They have a big long list of, like, suggested names and aliases and things that you could, like, use to describe their assorted fashion and style and stuff on the character creation page in the far right column. Do you have an idea right now of what this person is like, or do you want me to make Gareth's character and come back to you?
Make his character come back to me. I'll get it.
Okie dokie. Right then.
Okay, I think I've picked up a fair bit. So my character is going to be called York.
York? Alright.
His look is going to be hobo.
Okay. he's got, like, a really big, heavy winter's coat thing going on, lots of pockets.
A dirty parker. His background's going to be military. He's going to be a military veteran.
Okay.
Well, I'm less sad now.
All right, just to check, which playbook are you going for?
I'm a leech, sorry.
You're a leech? Okay, cool.
He was a saboteur in the army. He blew a lot of things up.
Okay.
He's hideously scarred now, but...
None of the leeches who turn up in this game ever have nice histories. The last one was a basically failed experiment.
He's hideously scarred, but he's got a really good mustache.
Good,
yeah.
Strong.
So
I think this is the world of really good mustaches.
Yeah. I'm going to put 1 point into wreck.
Okay.
Sorry, my special skill was saboteur. I'm not sure if I said that.
Cool. So that allows you to... When you wreck, the work is much quieter than it should be, and the damage is hidden from casual inspection. Okay. So you tinker of two. You now have a wreck of two. So obviously you've learned how to do a lot of damage while you were in the army. Where's the other one going for your time?
I'm going to put it into consort.
Consort. So how did you learn to consort better? Or is it just you were kind of well?
Does that have to be from the past rather than
now?
You can
give
because he's a drug addict now.
Okay.
So he consorts.
I mean, you get two other free points to kind of put wherever you fancy. So if you want to raise your consort to two, but then you're supposed to put in 2 points from like.
Okay, I'll go for prowl for my other.
That makes sense. Yeah, you're sneaky when you're essentially when you blow shit up for a living. Okay, and then one in consort, or are you going to bump?
Yeah, I'll put one in consort, and what's a tune?
A tune is the ghost field. It's your ability to
fuck ghosts.
Tune to spirits in the ghost field.
I'll go for survey.
Survey, okay. That's a useful skill for a person who, it's like, not want to know the lay of the land before you wander in and start strapping grenades to all of the bits of land you found.
Or who's looking to get high somewhere.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm guessing we already know your vice is again stupor.
to you.
Cool. A thing that you should just be aware of is if you look down at the bottom left of your character sheet, there's assorted things about the kind of poisons and drugs and such in this world. The essences, just so you know, are literally. Not burning bodies with electroplasm is very illegal because ghosts come out of them and then proceed to cause all kinds of issues, unless they're very properly disposed of. However, if you can manage it, you can trap the ghosts and then extract liquid emotion from their life. So essences are dead people's feelings bottled and sold as like the super drugs. So rage essence is actually like a carefully controlled substance, because it's basically like we shoot that into our super awesome soldiers and they go on a blood frenzy and are terrifying.
What about Black Lotus? That's the one that appeals to me. It sounds exotic.
I think that's kind of it's referenced in the book. It sounds kind of like the opium of this world. I mean, the only thing that we've really defined before is Skullfire under poisons, which is a kind of substance that once it makes contact with flesh, ignites in a sort of green flame. That is the only one that is defined. So if you want to make up how Black Lotus works, go for it.
I want to be a Black Lotus addict.
Okay. I'll let you think about how that all...
And I actually want it to be the flower that I just sniff. I just fucking stick it in my face.
Like, there is a defined refinery process, and you're just wandering around like looking really romantic, sniffing flowers, and just getting baked. Fabulous. Okay. Let me just make sure that's... Doodaloo, doodaloo. Yeah. That should be everything. So your guy's name is York.
Yes.
Does he have does he have an alias from his time in the army? Was he known?
Is he Tom York?
To be honest, that is his alias, and he got called it for so long he's forgotten his real name. He doesn't really care, so everyone just calls him York.
York. Cool. Alrighty. Yeah. Okay. So that's the leech. The last thing is, Carro, you're still operating out of that house you got given.
Uh-huh.
The little den you have. Have you named your crew yet? And evidently you've kind of recruited a few.
With a mighty cock.
Okay, we're back to that.
Yeah, because I am the mighty cock.
You see the link yet, guys? In chat.
Oh, God.
You asked for it.
Oh, my God.
The headphones make it 100%.
Absolutely.
What was that something?
That's beautiful.
What is this shit?
Don't check Twitter. I may have done some D&D in short tweets.
Oh God, no. Why are you the worst?
Oh, we matched.
Yeah, we do. Oh yeah. We've coordinated our closely.
Oh God, we're that.
Good job. Sick of myself.
You're both the worst. Great. So, that's assorted skills. Yes, I was talking about. So, features of this place that you have since discovered is that. How's that? Yeah. So there's actually like a random like room that's just full of crap. Just like assorted contraband that they must have stashed here and then never had anything to do with because they're some shady government organization. And so yeah, you've got this room full of stuff. If you look on the playbook for the thieves thing, that is the pack rats upgrade. I think there's also a bunch of thugs. So a cohort of thugs, as they're called in the book, who have probably are mates with Josh's character, I think, Took, or what's his name
Tink,
again?
Tonk. Tink or Tonk?
He was Tonk. Yeah. So, yeah, Tonk's character. It's like some drinking buddies of his have, like, kind of taken to hanging around in, like, the bottom floor, which is an old bar in there that doesn't really have anyone working there currently, but they just kind of sit there, bring their own booze, and will beat the shit out of people you tell them to as long as you're paying regularly.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So they are definably fearsome. That they're a scary bunch of bastards, but they're also savage. Like they enjoy the fighting a little too much. And yes, the other thing I will give you from this is I saw it. Where'd it go? Oh my God, I've lost. Oh yeah, you have. So you actually discovered in like, I think maybe one like, so Tink probably pulled these out from somewhere, and it's within like all of the assorted books and libraries in this place, you find like a perfectly preserved underground map of the city, including secret passages leading all over the place and stuff like that. So, yeah, you have a underground maps and passkeys, a skeleton key for the sewers, and knowledge of tunnels that aren't supposed to exist. So yeah, that might be useful to a bunch of aspiring thieves. Okay, so finally, Sydney. Tell us about your hound.
Oh, my dog?
No, your character first, and then about your ghost pop.
Oh, got it. Okay. Well, her name is Brenna.
Brenna.
And, yeah, what's that, Will, what's that show? What? It's Me or the Dog? Is that
it's
the
me
show?
It's Me or the Dog, yeah.
She looks like that girl.
You look like Victoria someone?
Yeah, she's like tall, she's got really long brown hair and bangs, and always wears red lipstick and a black trench coat.
Oh my God.
Yeah, digging it.
Okay, yeah, that's a look. Does she have an alias she functions under these days, or is it just Brenna, that fearsome woman?
The doctor? Yeah, I like that. I mean, like, she didn't give a fuck.
The handler or something.
Oh.
Okay, cool. Okay, so Brenna, she looks like that. Yep. And what about your dog?
His name is Barry.
Okay. Does he look at all strange, considering he's, like, ghost-touched?
He has a unicorn horn.
Right, cool, yep. wonderful. Unicorn horn dog. Sorry, no, all I can think of is, I don't know if any of you played the newest King's Quest, like, chapter, like they did an episodic King's Quest game, and the voice actor of SpongeBob plays a shady merchant whose carriage is pulled around by two unicorns, which are pigs with like shitty ass, like they look like fucking toilet roll. The thing is on the inside of a toilet roll, a little cardboard tube and a toilet roll just stuck to their heads and tapered at the point at the end. And it's just, don't touch the unicorns, they're a rare breed. That's all I can think of now. Yep, cool. Right, so we'd best get started then. So, Carro, you were approached by a lady called Madame Helena, who used to run... Well, she looks a little down on her luck. You knew her, she was owner...
I'm used to women down on their luck talking to me.
Yeah. You knew her as the owner of a place called the Silverlight Casino, place you frequented a lot when you were a man of more means. Although you've been
joint.
Yeah, you've been doing better recently.
Yeah, things picking up ever since I cast that last lightning storm.
Yeah.
And rode that giant whale home.
Yeah. And you know, Tonk took on a fucking army of ghosts by himself.
Yeah, that happened.
She's approached you and asked you to like kind of for a favor. And she kind of she's offers to buy you a drink if you'll hear her out.
Well, of course, yes, you can.
I was a bit too evil.
More bumbly.
Well, of course, yes, I'd love to. Thank you, my dear.
There we go. Back into Winston Churchill.
There we go. good, strong. So she sits you down and goes, "Some people have stolen my property from me."
Did I do that? Sorry.
No, Carro. I believe and understand you to be innocent in this. If only in this.
Oh yes. Definitely not me.
She kind of looks a little... I had some association with a woman called Caslin Mora. We met. It was a bit of a whirlwind romance. I didn't realize that she was actually...
Carro looks very shocked.
Yeah.
He's a man of his time.
What? But how does that...
She gives you like a kind of like, really, this is not the relevant part of the story.
How does that even work? Okay.
Shush. Didn't realize she's a con woman. She represents some of... some gang in the city. I don't know which one, but they've taken everything I've got.
Not my gang.
No, not your gang.
Not the Mighty Cock.
I wouldn't be here talking to you if it was you, Carro. The only reason I'm here talking to you is because I hear you have
my mighty. Oh yes.
Is because you've had some successes lately, despite your incredible aptitude to throw them all away. But frankly, I don't care what happens afterwards. I need you to rob my old casino and take every single penny from that cheating bitch.
We're going to need 11 people.
11 people?
Yes.
That's kind of on you.
The Chinese man who does the acrobatics thing, and we'll put him in and he'll get into
two
the vault.
Really attractive dudes, and also well, you convince your ex-wife to help you out.
Yes, where is Tess?
You're such an idiot. you've got the three players, you've got the like five thug guys who sit around downstairs. There's eight, you just have to find three more.
True, yeah.
But yeah,
Never mind, I'll put that one on hold.
Yeah.
Maybe a sequel. Anyway.
Get my revenge for me. You're welcome to everything in
there. Tell me more about this casino. What kind of defenses does it have?
You've been there a few times. It's on, it's a little up the dock. She kind of like, she reminds you of the location. She passed, like, she said, I haven't got any more It's on the dock side, up in the nicer districts away from the smell and bustle of the, like, the trading ship areas. I don't know of any particular weaknesses. They've replaced all the security in my old staff since they took it from me. These people don't play around. They ruined me just for a slight advantage.
Well, m'lady, what kind of compensation can I hope for my not inconsiderable talents?
Carro, you've been in my casino back when you were a man of means. Every man of means with a little passion for the dice gambles in that place. You're welcome to everything you find that you can carry, and preferably find a way to carry it all.
I am a big man.
I don't need I don't need any of the money, but here. And she like pulls out a like this like gray little key. Looks very like simple, is it? This gets you into the vault itself, as long as they haven't changed anything. There's some traps of your specialty around it, which I can't help you with.
I see.
It's tuned to, well, it was tuned to me, now it's tuned to them, presumably.
Tuna.
Precisely. Don't.
Now I'm hungry.
Don't be stupid.
Very well, it's...
That's your specialty.
I will leave us in my capable hands, m'lady, and I will see to this task, and thank you, and I will be on my way.
And I turn, and then I stop and turn back. But
seriously, how does that whole thing work?
Think scissors.
That sounds incredibly painful.
And then I walk away.
Good, good. Wonderful. Yeah. So...
I walk back to the crib.
Yeah, so... You two, tell me how Carro met you and like why you now hang out in the kind of weird little... the house of the mighty cock. It's like the house of the rising sun, only, you know...
just got a mighty
cock. It's just not as good a song.
I imagine he met me. I sleep outside on the floor. In this street, and I kind of, he maybe invited me in once for a drink because he felt sorry or he was drunk himself. But that's, yeah.
I feel like my dog, like, accidentally, like, hurt him one time with its unicorn horn, so now I feel bad and I'm like, I got to hang out with him.
I've never let it die. I'm just using it as an excuse to talk to her, like, oh, there's this unicorn.
Like, every time I try to leave, he's like, well, your dog did, like, impale me with a unicorn.
Yeah, he probably killed Tripsa.
Shit.
Hang out
with me.
Carro drunkenly stumbled out of a casino one evening, and the dog is running in the set, like, rolling the street. I'm like, yeah, go along, you can do it, Barrett. And bang, just stabs him through the thigh. Compensation, you now rob people for him. good. Okay. So,
ooh, let me remind some people of what's going on today. If you are watching along, you haven't hit that follow button, please do join the adventure and get following, because when we hit 1,100, which is only 7 followers away, then we have a viewer decision, which means you guys just get to decide anything which happens in our game. It could be a flying tortoise comes in and makes love to Carro. It could be literally anything. So, I mean, that's just on the top of my head. I definitely don't want that to happen. Totally not into total
sexually
porn,
harassing tortoise. But
anything can happen.
I've made a creepy over affectionate vampire before for this.
That's true. And of course, we're giving away a copy of the Sword Coast Adventurer's Guide! ! Giveaway, and you can go and win a copy of that. So take it away.
Okay, so yeah, so you're all assembled, waiting, like planning out the new job, and this is where I shall direct the team. So you have, like, you know where the place is, you've got access to all the resources previously mentioned, and your own brains. If you look at, the page has moved, why has the page moved? No, why would you do this to me? So on page 16 of the PDF, there is a thing about planning. But basically, how this game works is that we don't bother with the nitty-gritties of sitting here for an hour while you go, well, if we access the tunnel from here and then we do that, because balls to that. You pick a plan, so whether you're going to go in guns blazing, tell them all to stick them up and shoot them if they don't, whether you're going to like try to lie your way down to the vault, whether you're going to just sneak in, use weird magical powers, confront or exploit a supernatural power, whether you'll be social and try to like persuade them to just give you the money, The transport one never seems to really apply that I can find. So you pick a plan, and then for each plan, a specific kind of detail has to be used. So if it's an assault, it's where are you attacking? Are you walking through the front door, got like guns in the air, so everyone put your hands up, jewelry in the bag, move along, or are you going to like wait till it's like closed at some point and try to bat the shit out of the security guards who keep it locked? So on and so forth. So basically, what style of... What's your style, team? What's squad aesthetic?
York only ever has one suggestion, and that's to blow it up.
No, York, the thing is, if we blow it up, there won't be any money left inside, and the money is what we want.
I just love the idea of, like, the entire team going in there and be like, that's some, like, nice money, can I have it?
Yeah, you might be do. That would kind of be the detail of, like, so who are you going to try and convince to get, like... Because, I mean, you could go in pretending to be clients and, like, try and seduce someone and be like, well, I bet you got... I don't know how you get down to the vault room using your silver tongue, but I'm sure your player characters, that's not my job to think of that. That's your job.
No.
Can I have it? They say no, and you say, why not?
But I want it. Carro's like, yeah.
So, we're not going to just hit one casino, we're going to hit three. At the same time.
This is just like Ocean's 11, that's what this is!
Really? Is this a... Welcome to the joke.
Wait, did I miss... Was that...
Yeah,
like...
we were.
The whole thing about we're going to need 11 people, we're going to find his ex-wife.
I didn't even pick up on it until now. Never mind, you know what? I should hang up.
Good in DiMellagio, Liam Jim Gran. He torpedoed my casino.
See, I know this, like, the thing is, I know this film so well. I'm never going to stop referencing it.
Yeah, so the place you're robbing is called the Silverlight Casino. I don't know if I might have missed that detail.
Yeah, Silverlight, okay.
Can we not blow things up a little bit?
Maybe a little bit, yeah, sorry.
Just so you are aware, there is also a thing in this game of, basically, you know that bit where, in all the good movies, where, like, for instance, Ocean's 11, where I'm going to reveal the twist ending of Ocean's 11 right now, and it's all, they were robbing a different casino the whole time. There is a thing in this game called flashbacks, where you go, oh yeah, this is where, like, at this point, we knew this was going to happen, and you expend some stress, and you get to add something to the thing, so it's like, you can say, oh yeah, we knew our escape route was going to be we put a raft in the sewer system below this casino and then you blow a hole in the vault like bottom and it just all fall, the money falls to the bottom of the vault straight into the thing or something equally ridiculous. That is a thing you can do as well.
Okay, so I say, I know a bunch of ghost shit, right?
It's good.
Tends to go well. So... why don't we enter via some kind of ghostly passage? Sometimes I can find these teleport points which I can make us step through, and there are, she said, ghostly defenses, so it makes sense there might be one around. Sound good? What's your name again, girl with dog?
You can call me girl with dog. That's my Indian name.
I thought you have to say Native American over there these days. Is that not like a thing?
Is that okay? Are we allowed to stream this?
I think it's the other one from OK. What's it? What's it? Bad. Bad.
Racist.
Okay, so,
okay, girl.
Brenner.
Yes, Brenner of Tarf. Good. Let's use the dog somehow. How about we strap explosives to the dog?
Send
in the dog.
York could be rubbing his hands together.
York's pulled out like a measuring tape and is like measuring the dog. how much C4 can I fit on a dog?
I'll whisper to her, how much cavity is there?
Oh my god.
You know, one day you're gonna have to get over this bitterness of the one time Barry stabbed you in the thigh. and quit trying to blow him up.
Well, okay, not...
It'll not be this day.
Not this day.
This day we fight.
There. Maybe next week.
Yeah, I say, very well, and not that way. None of you look particularly charming, so I don't think we're going to be able to talk our way in here. Okay, yes, sorry. Barry does look rather charming. In this certain light, yes. Other than that, though, I think ghostly teleport shit might work.
Ghostly teleport shit.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Sums up this game.
What do you think? Or should we just go with the Mighty Cock suggestion?
What?
I am the Mighty Cock.
Yeah, I think one of the five like thug guys you have lying around just kind of wanders past that moment, like to get another bottle out of the like the back room, which is kind of here. You go, I am the Mighty Cock. You just hear a what? Oh, back in a bit.
Guys, I can leave you alone if you want.
Just me and the dog. You do that.
I think there is more than the doors.
Oh my god. Oh.
There will be shortly.
I broke him again.
I'm good.
Alright, so we go. I think we're going with ghostly teleport shit.
Okay, so. The plan is to try and use like the ghostly residue around this this vault as a way to kind of like anchor yourself.
Penetrate.
You move through the next world briefly.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
not a pleasant or fun experience for anyone. Okay. So that begins with so I have to roll fortunes to see how horribly fucked you are. I mean, how well you're going to do on your great plan. So!
This session's a good one because Will is more awake for it.
So, we have targets. I think, so they literally have that you were warned about ghost preparations. So the target is well prepared for, especially because ghost crime is on the rise.
It's real terror. They're trying to crack down on it, but they're cutting the police. Budget.
1d6. Let's see how terribly things are going.
Can I just point out, my body is completely strapped up with explosives.
Oh yeah, I'm presuming you brought a fair chunk. I'm just waiting for you to fail.
Not a patch, yes. Just
where the fuck does a homeless man get explosives?
He doesn't have a home, man. He doesn't have any of that. He doesn't have a mortgage to pay.
He doesn't have a home.
All of his income
just goes straight towards.
You'd be surprised where you can keep stuff.
Okay, yeah. So, you're like, I think you're nearby, and you find a kind of a nexus of otherworldly energies, and you manage to like open your brain to the ghost field.
Feels
and,
good, man.
Start moving through the kind of the back ways of the world. You get nearby, like you find this like glowing point at the center of it all, where this safe is. You can tell there's some fancy ass electroplasmic stuff happening there, but you can't get too close to it because the protection's around it. There's a convenient way out, and as you like, you're kind of forced through that. Like it's almost like a river running out of a drainage point, and you're all log fluming behind Carro. You just kind of tossed back out into the real world. And you're in what looks like kind of maybe a room for like a private game. So there's like it's a small little room. You will land on like the card table. And kind of, there's no one in here currently. It's very dark. But Carro, just before you get there, you sense someone else, like following just along, and they, you feel them kind of get diverted off and somewhere else into the building. So there's other people coming for this place too.
Where we like land,
I'm like, there are other people around here, so be on your guard. Sorry, that was rather ominous. Just, there are people around here. Should put a watch out, probably.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah, you're in the casino. You all have like the kind of gear you bring with you on this sort of job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What do you
like,
do, team?
You bring like dog snacks.
Are we in like tuxedos to make sure we don't?
I mean, is the plan to then walk out the door and be like, we're super fancy and we totally should be here, or is the plan to try and sneak around?
Because totally. Let's
next
wear suits.
Step, you've brought the gear appropriate to your next step.
Let's wear suits because then like Carro's totally into trying to do Ocean's 11, but because he's an idiot, like with Lee's three people, like and himself, like it's clearly never gonna work. But he's like, oh, it'd be just like this film I saw once.
I want to wear a suit too. I want to be disguised as a boy.
That okay. Shouldn't be hard. Good.
Damn. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So I guess this is a. How well does the guy who maybe has just about managed to stretch himself to a shave and a shower, the person who smells of wet dog, and the bumbling man who's famous for being a complete asshole in these circles, how well do you move through this this fancy casino? So I think that's a consort, because it's not a prowl. It's how well you all do in a big social environment.
Sorry, so we just roll a 1d6.
So you roll the number of d6s you have dots. So Sydney will roll... I'll let Carro lead this. There's mechanics in the game for people leading actions. So Carro, you have... Actually, you have a decent consort, if I remember correctly. You have one. So you have 1d6. Sydney, you will roll 2d6 and take the worst one. And Gareth, you have one as well.
I rolled a 4.
I rolled a 2. I take it as
it's not the best. It's not the best.
It's stressful is what it is.
The smell of
give me a second roll, Sydney, because we take the crappier one for you. Okay, that's 2 threes. So that's 2 results below 3. So yeah, your friends are idiots, Carro. They do not know how to behave
yes.
in this kind of situation. So yeah, you step out of this room, you kind of like... shed off your skulky we can survive in the ghost field gear and yeah you're I think so Carro you're there in like your resplendent noble gear and you turn around and like they're dressed so just wrong.
I forgot to buy them suits.
Damn it.
Like, I think it's so yeah so maybe so get so York like bought a suit jacket but like there's just patches where this from like a pawn shop. There's patches where people have sewn just random different colored stuff over the top. He looks like a children's TV presenter from, and yeah, Brenna just like for some reason has tried to disguise that like, he's wearing like a full on tuxedo, but looks more dressed for like a wedding. Like the top hat and tails and all this jazz, but in no way is it like still has like long hair. And it's like, it just looks like, okay.
Okay, so here's what we go with. I've got enough. Wait, no, you're my bride, and that's our son. I point to the dog. And...
with like a wig on him.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
No, it's a boy.
So the scene of this is you're
our driver.
A dog, which has a horn, just like is wrapped in a blanket going.
He's a special son.
We're like really defensive about him, so. He's not well.
Yeah, so you walk out into the casino, and yeah, it's a very nice looking place. There's lots of tables, everyone's dressed very nicely, there's lots of fancy jewelry. People here are well off. There's no tables aren't raking in a lot of money.
Welcome to my world, my friends.
You say to the children's presenter, the person carrying a dog baby, for some reason dressed as like they're getting married in the 16th century.
Now then, I'm just off to do a few slots, and then we'll see about all this, whatever we're here for.
Carro is, like, immediately drawn towards the gambling, because he's an addict.
Of course, yeah. So what's Carro's game?
His game is so strong.
I know that.
First of all, he probably goes for some blackjack. It's a bit of blackjack.
Okay, yeah, so, So before I get into what happens to Carro, you sit down, you start playing a few hands. You're doing okay, but you're not like, you've got a bigger thing at the moment, but it's hard to resist the urge to play a couple of hands, see where your luck's at.
Yeah.
What are the other two of you doing, just to like, blend
I'm trying
in?
To burp my dog.
You're just standing over him like playing cards, just like. I imagine this is like, it's this person, like, there's another table just on the opposite side, like the walkway. And, it's like this, and he gets to leave, just turns and double takes. And it's like you get like the mind link opens up as your dog is just like having a staring contest with this shocked woman. Just like, and you see it and just walk away. What about York?
I'm going to go to the bar and I'm going to try and order a fancy cocktail that I don't know the name of any, so I'm just going to make one up and try and just stare at the barman until he makes it.
Yeah. Oh, no. Deadpan. So,
yeah,
of course.
Deadpan. Blue Russian, please.
Russia doesn't exist. That's even weirder. And he's like, yep, absolutely.
He's like Scrumpy Jack.
He somehow puts this like ridiculously spindly looking martini glass with a bright blue liquid in it and goes, yes, that'll the name's a price that's like you could probably buy like a month's supply of explosive chemicals for what you just named for this one drink.
And I'll say, it's on that guy, and I'll pick someone else in the casino. Just point at them at random.
Of course, sir. Of course.
I'll go chin chin and I'll down it in one, whether I'm mental or not.
He just nods and moves along. Cool. Yeah, so Carro, you're playing a couple rounds, a couple hands, as I say. You're doing fine. Nothing amazing. Nothing bad.
The thing with Carro is once he starts, he just can't stop. That's his problem.
Yeah, I always gathered that. Until a friend. So someone sits down next to him and goes, Carro. Always fun. And Jess, it is.
Do I recognize this?
You do indeed recognize this person. Their name is... So they are Quellen.
Oh, posh boys.
Yeah, so it's a guy who would be like kind of a peer in your arcane study. And he goes, I thought I sniffed you on the way in. You're still an amateur when it comes to using the passions of the ghost world, it seems.
What are you talking about, Quellen?
He gives you a look. It's like, come on. Not even you're that blind. I take it you're here for the... And he kind of looks around. Safeness? Safety of retirement and such downstairs?
There's a safe here. Well, that would make sense. Ah, interesting. No, I'm just here to try my hand at cards. You know what I'm like.
So you used arcane forces to come play some cards. Because I know they won't let you in at the door anymore, Carro.
That's how I travel these days. How else would I get in?
Quite. I must say, he kind of looks at the lady burping a dog. You travel with some interesting company these days.
We're engaged.
There's a new Finn Bear link.
Yeah. That's pretty great. Nice one, Kent.
It's getting more erotic.
This is what happens when Finbar comes on stream.
I love it.
The worst. I look
that
so
means, like, the next t-shirt.
Next t-shirt ink.
Yeah, I love it.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess I say, oh no. They're not with me.
Can I walk over at this point?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm going to say, who's this twat?
I'm Carro, we've met.
No, the other twat.
I mean, we haven't met. Oh, but
Quello kind of looks at you guys. I see. Well, a word of a health warning for you all. I represent some other interests this evening, Carro. Don't get in our way. And he stands up and like tosses his hand back, and goes, "Have a lovely evening now."
Would you stay for a round?
I would, but you know.
Oh, still a pussy, then.
Work to do.
That's what he said.
I want Barry to burp in his face.
Absolutely.
Can that happen?
Yeah. You're gonna like. Lovely animal you've got there.
Can I look him over, like, a subtle glance and see if he's carrying anything?
Sure. That, I guess, would that be...
Survey?
Yeah, I think that'd be survey. Ghost situation is like... Yeah, sure. Give me a survey roll. So, this is... You're up against people who are trying to be stealthy, so it's so the way this... game we had. Okay. Do you already have the one survey? So to let you know, just some extra things. So you can do things such as, in this game, there's things of you can use your stress to give you better chances to do stuff. Which includes, so you can add, so you can take two stress and get an extra dice, or you can try and take a devil's bargain, which is where if anyone at the table can think of a bad consequence for doing something, you get an extra dice for that. Doesn't necessarily mean, and it happens whether you succeed or fail. So just so you know, in the future, for like late rolls, if something matters to you, you've got a those routes. So this was difficult on a 1 to 3. Things go badly. You suffer harm. Complication occurs. You're in a desperate position. You lose opportunity for action. Yeah. So you like you see Quellen walk over and he like whispers in the ear of this big guy. And I think you follow along, and you're like trying to follow them as they move across the floor, and this larger gentleman bumps into you and goes, "Sir, can I assist you with anything? You appear to be taking an unhealthy interest in my friends."
I've just pissed myself and I wanted to go to the toilet.
Very But I can tell you, my associates over there appreciate you bringing this issue to them.
Oh, gentlemen, I come over and slap an arm round York. I say, "Oh, he's not going to be any trouble here, are you, old Bill?" Bill? See, he's harmless. He can't even speak, really.
I have pissed myself, though.
Yes, I can feel the warmth as we speak. Really, really wasn't a lie.
Where did you put your arm when you put it around?
I did not specify. Nor will I.
I walk back and just kind of spit in that guy's general direction.
Okay. Yeah, so you see, like, you, as you're turning, you see him walking over to, like, the pit boss, this little area, and you see him, like, pointing in your direction and whispering in this dude's ear. And the pit boss kind of, like, nods and makes a gesture towards some like people at the door who look like security for this place. The guy kind of gives you a look of this kind of very flat, icy stare before he goes over. And so, Carro, you see Quellen disappear behind like a velvet rope into what looks like a restricted area. And they've just used you as a distraction. Mm. So, yeah.
Damn it. Quillen's got it in there now. We'll have to follow him. Actually, we'll have to create a distraction. I think York, you might be just a man for this job.
Okay, what do you want me to do?
Just
be yourself.
This could be a place for a flashback if you'd already planned, like, okay, so we get onto the casino floor, we mingle for a little while, and then York causes some chaos, which we use to slip away to the thing. That's totally quite a reason. What you want to do. So just let me remind myself of exactly how this works. So tell me what kind of thing you knew you were going to do, like, to cause some panic, York.
He's going to walk over to the nearest table that's stacked with chips, and he's just going to attempt to fucking flip it everywhere.
I was okay, right? It's not, you're not going for, like, but there's no, like, you've not been actually wandering around while you've been sipping your Blue Russian, setting up anything. Like, it's just, nah, fuck it. Literally kick a table over.
Subtlety is not my middle name at this point. I'm going to just fucking go for it.
Okay, yeah, well, that's just, there's no stress for that. That's just like, okay, yeah, we're going to go in, and then York, you're going to cause a scene. Okay, so... I think, yeah, you can just do that, and then the security who are kind of just wandering towards you, like, pick up some pace and start running for you.
And then I'll attempt to run in the different way, maybe towards a toilet or something, that and draw them away from the rest of the guys.
Okay, so I think that is a prowl. So it's, climb, swim, run, jump, and tumble. To me, this sounds like, to elude them and hide correctly, it sounds like prowl to me. So you have a one in prowl. One in prowl.
Yeah.
Do you want to use any stress or anything like that to get more dice?
I'll try and go with it. At this point, I'm cool.
Hit me.
Four.
Okay. So again, I always forget to do the position stuff. So the thing about this game, sorry, is that there's like, when you make a roll, you are in one of three different positions. You are in the dominant position, where it's quite safe. You're doing things on your own terms, that kind of stuff. The difficult position, where you're going head to head with someone of equal skill. And the desk position, where you are on the back foot, and if you fuck this up, bad things happen. Most of the time, things are difficult, because, you know, you don't do easy things, because easy things don't pay well. Difficult. You go head-to-head, you act on five, you take a risk. On 4-5, you do it, but there's a consequence. You suffer harm, a complication occurs, or you end up in a desperate position. Yeah, so, the security kind of gets led off. So Carro and Brenna have an opportunity to make for whatever route they'd pre-planned. York, you get, like, chased away from where you're supposed to be in the next part of the plan. So you manage to conceal yourself, but you're kind of lost right now. And you are a little bit of a sticky situation, because there's a bunch of people hunting for that guy in the weird patchwork coat. Yes, which is the point. I should make another...
We like that. Try and book it for the
Yeah, cool. So where are you? Are you headed straight for the vault? Or do you have a?
I'm gonna follow where Quillen went.
Okay.
Be on his trail.
Yeah. So is the plan to catch up with him and ambush him?
Yeah. Because he's clearly trying to get in on my.
On
my joint.
I think that's probably a prowl from you guys to run after him.
Come on, this prowl.
Yeah, it's kind of. This is just sprinting after him as fast as you fucking can. So, again, there's two of you, so you can do the teamwork thing. It would make sense that if, I think, Brenna was on point for this, because she's more athletic and has this kind of stuff down. A little better than you do.
I'm a pretty fat guy.
Yeah, so... So once again, either of you can increase your own dice pool by taking Devil's Bargains, expending stress... And also, Carro, you can take one stress, I suppose two, to give Brenna an extra die, if you want. Just so you're aware, that's how these specific thingies work. Do bear in mind, if any time I give you a consequence of, like, you are being hunted down, or you're pinned in a location that you don't want to be in, you can say, nah, mate, and we can roll some dice and sort that out. So, just so you know. But yes, so, if you aren't taking any... abilities right now, Brenna roll one dice, 1d6, and Carro roll two and take the worst one.
All right.
Boom!
Two.
Oh, wait, no, you have so that's a two for you, so that does give Brenna one stress.
I'm a fat man, I'm like, urgh,
urgh. Yeah. but Brenna, like, you've got Barry, like, snapping behind him, forcing him to speed up.
Oh, he's what? I have, like, Barry, and I'm holding him like this with the horn, like, pointing in his back. Go, go, go!
Is that the best time bark ever, or what?
Yes.
Oh, dear, this all feels very Benny Hill right now.
We're just,
the camera is, like, showing doorways through this hallway in the casino, and we just see Carro sprinting, being chased by a woman holding a dog, like a spear. It's like, fantastic. Okay, yeah, so on a six, you do it. You round a corner and you find, the door that leads down into the basement levels. you find these three men, including Quellen, and like Quellen and him are standing back. The other weird guy like sees you as you come around the corner, and the third one is at the doorway, picking the locks. It seems from this angle.
Happy fight.
What do you do?
What's the attack word for a dog?
Impale.
Makes sense. Impale.
Okay, so this is turning into a fight. Are you like pulling pistols out and going, and there's lots of like diving through the air and screaming and shooting, or you throw in lightning bolts? What do you do? What do you guys do as well as release the hound?
I've got my like sword cane thing, so I'm gonna swat at this guy.
Stepping into the fray. This is good because you have no skill in this stuff.
I might have a pistol actually.
Yeah, no, you guys all have guns and swords. Depends what you brought with you. I presume you bring some guns because you're not stupid.
Right? I probably have like a pistol I should just go in with before going to the old Kanaroo.
Brenner, I assume you follow suit. There's a hallway, you have guns. Stand in a straight line. Just blow them away.
Yeah.
You though do have a thing of you as a fancy hound, you have a fine pair of pistols. So what Kara's using some like 10-cent store piece of crap. Like do your pistols have anything particular to them? Are they like blue coat issue good stuff because you're an ex like sniffer dog trainer?
Yeah, they're like really nice. They're platinum and every time you shoot them they bark.
It's like glyphs drawn in electroplasm on the side that flare with light. Wonderful. All right. So this is a hunt roll. So Brenna, that's 2d6 from you, and Caro, 2d6, take the worst one from you. Again, stress and all that. If you want it. Here's the thing.
All right.
I will offer probably Brenna because I think she's again on point because she's real, real good shot. So devil's bargain. No matter how this goes, so you can have an extra die. But about how well this goes, the security of this place will hear this gunfight and start coming this way. That's my devil's bargain. You can bring some heat down on yourself, but have a better chance of just murdering these fools and getting down into the vault faster.
The devil is definitely more dark.
Do it.
I don't think that's a good idea.
But I didn't say it was a good idea.
I don't want to do that.
Okay. That's fine. After.
That's fine.
Don't take my bargain. Whatever.
That's cool. Shoot the crap out. Alright, that's a 6. So once again, you're doing pretty well. Add a 4 from Kara, so no stress for Brenna. And yeah, you fucking nail them.
Nailed it, boys.
So, this is difficult. There's 3 of them, there's 2 of you, so there's no real big scale difference, especially because one of them's like fiddling with something else and doesn't have time to react. So, as you do it, oh god, where's the thing about effect stuff?
Also, I've been streaming for 420 right now. The boys!
Blazer and such.
Blazer in D&D.
You have really nice guns, so the rat-a-tat of sounds. I think that's so. These guys, blow the big guy like reaches into his jacket and before he even brings his gun to bear, you've like put, like you've triple tapped him. Caro, you shoot meaning to hit Quellen and you splatter the guy who's picking the locks, and Quellen kind of just backs up. I'm a freelancer.
Oh, Quellen, you thought you were better than us, didn't you?
Yes, I didn't quite expect to come around and murder these guys.
Why not?
Just killed 2 red sashes, man.
Tell me about it.
Jesus!
Are you going to get us into this vault, or am I going to have to shoot your brains out?
Fine, yeah, whatever. I don't know, open the door, though. He was only halfway done before you... Ugh.
Well, you hurry up and start doing it. I've just spilled vodka on my thigh.
Can't tell whether that's in fiction or in real life.
You don't want to know.
He kind of gives you a look like, I don't know how to lockpick.
Well, you better fucking learn quickly.
Maybe we can use. We can use Barry's horn to pick it.
Okay, so this surreal discussion is going on.
I'm Bruno is suggesting.
Don't think his sex drive's gonna help here.
You're like hiding behind like a big suit of armor that's on display in one of these hallways. And like two guards just run past you, but you can hear them like the other. They're like the perfect description of the guy who wasn't there. Of you two, a guy who wasn't there. Like the security are looking for you. You're in the wrong part of the house for your like to be with the team and break into this vault. What do you do?
What do you? Sorry.
Okay.
Go ahead, Carro.
I'm going to look round. Is there maybe a lady in a big fur coat or something like that?
So you want to try and like sneak back in and what's your...
I'm going to drop my jacket where I am.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to attempt to grab a fur coat or something like that that's big and can cover me and hide who I am.
Okay.
And try to get back to where they are.
Okay, so that, yeah, so your plans are like, oh, you pop up in the door of the cloakroom and see what...
Yes.
See. Okay. Is that a skill or is that just like, are you lucky enough to find a giant ass fur coat?
I'm going to do a survey to see if I could find one.
You don't find a fur coat, you just find a collection of trash bags. You have to convert.
Or an adequate disguise, I'm not specifying.
Yeah. That's fine. I'm just trying to remember. There is a specific thing for like when you're just kind of trusting your to the luck of everything.
Sketch rewind asks Sydney, when you do the killing shot, the gun howls? Question mark. It was ow.
When was that?
It's when you pop bullets into people.
When I shoot things, it.
Yeah. So two people have just died. Carro, because you're kind of sensitive to ghost stuff, you hear the. Dong! As the bell in the Spirit Warden's tower sounds
calls me.
People having been killed. So yeah, you have got maybe an hour or two before the Spirit Wardens arrive here to burn the bodies and make sure there's no ghosts.
Cool.
And also then blue coats rock up to be like, there's been a murder!
Yeah, it's never good. I say to Brenna,
the Donga has told it's time for us to get going quickly. You, Quentin! Quillin.
Get this door open.
Justin, whatever your name is.
Justin.
Yeah, sure, give me that survey, York. Do you want to use any stress at all?
Yeah, I will use a stress to make this happen. I'm really
excited
to make this happen.
I will tick some stress up on your thing.
Fuck, Rich, just
don't. Roll 2d6.
I've not rolled anything other than a 2.
Okay, Doodaloo. So, that's not good. That's not good. Things go badly, you suffer harm, a complication, because you're in a desperate position, you lose this opportunity for action. So I think it's... I'll give you a choice here. You see what might be, like, a decent, like, okay, yeah, no, I can make it over there, and then duck into that little hallway, like, there should be enough for gap, and then someone just literally walks... into like the mouth of the hallway and turns around and faces like outwards onto the floor. So there is a guy just standing right in your way now. So you can either just go, you know what, I'm gonna see if there's another way around and try and navigate the maze of this building a different way. Or you can just try and run at him and knock him the fuck over. Okay.
Run at him and knock him the fuck over.
Okay, so that is a skirmish roll, definitely. Like, you're trying to fight your way through here.
I have nothing in, I don't believe.
Yes, so when you have no dice pool, you roll 2d6 and take the worst one. And this is definitely a desperate situation because, you're trying to burst your way through all this fucking security by yourself.
Sorry, guys. Oh, for...
Oh, well. Oh, damn. It's the worst outcome. You suffer severe harm, a serious complication occurs, or you lose this opportunity for action.
Thank you to True Emrys for following. Welcome to the adventure, my friend.
Okay.
You're a gentleman sconcer. But he's 6 followers away from a viewer decision, boys.
Dun 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 dun. Where's the harm thing gone? There it is. Okay. Yeah, you start, like, barreling down this hallway, and he, like, turns and sees you, and, like, reaches into his pocket and flicks out this, if you've played Dishonored, the sword that's kind of like, so it looks a bit like a butterfly knife as a handle, and you flick it, an entire sword blade comes out, and he, like, spins and hacks at your leg as you run past.
Oh, my God.
And opens a pretty nasty, a wicked nasty cut. So this would be a slashed up leg. Would be so the way we'd record this is it's severe harm, which basically means that you're kind of a bit screwed. However, you can attempt to resist this by dipping into your stress pool if you would like to do that.
Yes, I would like to do that.
Okay, so let me just find the exact ruling. Where the fuck is it gone? resistance roll. But you roll the less stress it costs to avoid the danger. Okay, so you resist it with physical prowess, which is based off of which skills? Come on. Finesse, prowess, skirmish, and wreck, which you have. So, roll 2d6 for me.
Well, I'm guaranteed a 2. Two okay. Fours, there we go.
A four is respectable. So you take, I believe it's 6 stress minus 4. So for a total of 2 stress, and yeah, like, so you, literally this blade passes within an inch and you kind of like, I think it's you just jump, and like tuck and roll, and like you feel the blade like skim across your back, and like your shirt takes maybe your trouser leg gets cut open, but you manage to just dodge the blade, and yeah, you kind of tuck and roll and land, and you're like, life flashing rapidly before your eyes. You are on the other side of that, but yeah, you've just landed in the middle of the room, and it's not good. Do you have any, like... I'll give you... So maybe stop using skills that are terrible for you, but you do have, as you put, bombs and poisons strapped to you.
Can I... Would I have a smoke bomb, maybe?
Oh, absolutely. That's definitely...
Something non-lethal
going,
that I can throw down that...
There's a poison called choke dust?
Yeah. That sounds lethal.
I don't know. I think that you're
just a gentle choke.
I think you're an accomplished enough
okay.
alchemist.
I will try and use a non-lethal dose of that.
Cool.
To create cloud of poisonous gas that causes everyone to cough and it lose a line of sight.
Cool. Yeah. So give me a wreck to give you some cover.
Which is 2d6, and I'll take the best one.
Yes.
5.
5 is good. So yes, you do it. Okay, so... Yes, I think you tuck and roll, you land, your, like, coat has come off, and you have this weird, like, assorted kind of network of random vials and things, and you pull one off and just toss it down. It's a tiny little bottle, and it hits the ground, and then just, like, bubbles. And then, this massive cloud covers the room. And just you look up, and just as it's like going, poof, this guy levels a pistol and shoots at you. One of the security guards running down, like in the room. So you take a bullet to like the where's so this is definitely painful but not really debilitating. So I think you take it to maybe like your forearm.
Yeah. Bicep or something like that.
Yeah. So like it hurts like a bitch, and it will. Make your life tricky. So the basic consequence of this is that doing anything that require usage of your hand, of both hands, I'll give you that, because you're competent enough that maybe with one hand you'd be okay, you are losing a dice.
Okay.
To the roll, unless you'd like to resist with stress again, but be careful because you're already at 4.
Yes.
You're gonna go up to 8.
Sorry, just out of character, can we do anything to reduce this stress?
Not in the mission itself, okay. Unless you have armor, which if you guys have worn armor underneath your clothing, you can expend armor to just negate the effects of something I say at some point. So like say you were wearing like some kind of, I don't know, bit of leather armor and stuff, and I say, yeah, you get shot, and it's like, no, I don't, but then your armor's busted, and like the bullet would hit it, it would crumple and would completely lock your arm down until you take the armor off and move along. Or it takes the cut, but then is cut off of you. That kind of deal. Okay. Yeah. You could probably just about fit armor and a weapon and all this poisonous stuff on you.
I don't imagine I'd go for armor.
That's fair. I'm just letting you know that it exists.
Yeah, no doubt.
Cool, yes. But, yeah, it's successful. Your smoke cloud covers this place. You pull up a little, I don't know what... do you have, like, a thing that lets you breathe safely enough as, like, treated cloth or something like that to...
Yeah, I imagine I've got some nasty-looking scarf, which is... It covers the smell and stops me breathing it in.
Yeah. Meanwhile, yeah, there's, like, a bunch of rich hoity-toity folks all choking in this room as it billows out into the main floor. And, yeah, you have perfect cover to leg it and try and catch up. So the sounds of screaming and then choking starts echoing down from the main room as... kind of, you see Quellen looking a bit panicked, having been told, I'm gonna shoot you if you don't break this door down. And he just goes, well, nothing for it, I guess. And he puts his hands out, and you see the door, like, chill. Like, you see, like, kind of a frost forming on it. And then,
it's got no chill.
And then just, like, icicles explode out of the lock. And then just, like, kind of almost, so you get an icicle comes out of the lock, and then out of, like, other points of the door. And then you just get the door kind of shudders, and this like giant ice ball just like pushes itself out through the kind of hinge, and the door handle falls to the ground, and it kind of knocks it in. It goes, that may have drawn a little bit of attention. Yeah.
I say.
You hear a kind of the soft wail of the ghost field go like disquieting around that.
So are we like in?
You are into like the. Kind of this set of stairs takes you down into kind of the basement floor where the vault is kept.
Cool. I say, about time, Quillen. Now keep moving.
Oh, good. Yes. Yeah, so yeah, you start moving in. Brenna, I think you get like there's a little bruff, in your head, and then like one eye like flicks over to Barry Vision, and sees
Barry Cam.
Like running out of this cloud, pulling the
Barry Cam is
it's got constant like just that the vision always goes.
You're looking through the funhouse mirror.
Yeah. So yeah, Barry like comes. No, sorry, York comes running out of the cloud that's filling up the main room and after you. He's not far behind. And then yeah, you're back.
Should wait for him.
Yeah, he'll catch up shortly. But yeah, so you guys get to the bottom of the stairs, and there's a like kind of. So I think this is like a much like it's a way less decorated. This like down here in the basement. You've got so the hall like the kind of hallway leads off into like you've got like wine cellars and things like that, and then yeah, this big like, fortified set of doors with two guards standing outside it as you kind of lead around the corner. And yeah, what's the plan, team?
Maybe I think
Gareth at this point like pulls up next to you and is like,
sorry, I got a little bit lost.
Never mind, you're here now. There are a couple of guards I could do if you're distracting, and this could be in any way you like. I know you do have some more explosive ways.
Do I get to blow the door open now?
Yes, but remember what I told you. Only blow the bloody doors off.
But the door's already been opened.
Oh, there's more, and there's still a vault to get into. Okay. Also, then a vault to get out.
What I'll do is try and I'll set up some explosives. So, are we going inside or are we staying outside? Yeah,
there's basically some like this kind of room is like guarded, but has some guards who are like there's no pretense that they're there to be like they're not bouncers. Their armed security with like obvious proper swords and pistol strapped them like standing guard outside this big set of like heavy doors at the end of this hallway in the basement.
Okay, well I'm hoping I've got one vial that's I chuck in first and that's just going to be like a weird gas that gets their attention and brings them in, and the next one I chuck in sets everything aflame and causes that to burst and set fire to them.
Okay, cool.
So is that a 2d6 for wreck?
Welcome. Place item, obstacle, salvage, force, kept by sabotage.
Thank you, Sildari, for falling. Welcome to the adventure, my friend, your gentleman.
Yeah.
And a skull. So we're only 5 followers away from that viewer decision. So get following if you haven't already. And go into that giveaway for the Sword Coast Adventurer's Guide! Exclamation point giveaway.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely a wreck. I'll let you...
Oh, absolutely
my
wrecked.
God.
Gareth, best blades in the dark player, EU.
So you did have the advantage here, because you could have jumped out from surprise and just threw these things in. But yeah, so like, I think it's, you're supposed to throw them in quick succession. You leap out, you throw the first one, and like this stuff lands and the gas starts to spread. And then you like try to toss the second one and your arm fails you as the pain like washes over. And like you just kind of fumble it and it drops and just bounces off the floor. And like rolls over to the side, like rolls over, not broken. So there's no ignition going on. They kind of stumble out of the cloud. So you lose your dominant position of surprise, and now it's kind of, they're like pulling swords and guns off and like taking aim. So, yeah, who steps up as like, kind of York like clutches his arm in pain. Quellen kind of goes, meep. What's the plan, team?
Send in the hounds. Or just Barry.
That might be dangerous. Do
you think there's people running at you. Like, the guns are firing.
Yeah. No time to lose.
This is the time to discuss. This is the time for action.
Yeah, let Barry run and, like, stab people in the leg.
Wait, let me say this. Unleash the hound. Now
oh
do
my
it.
God.
Now
okay.
do it.
Now
do
we
it
can
now.
Go.
There we go. Good.
Sick 'em.
That should be the attack word. Words.
Discussion. And people, like, pulling guns and fire. That should be an attack, but we have to do that from now on.
We
all right.
Of that.
Yeah. So, well, I guess, is this, yeah, like, hound, like, leaps on one of those, like, tearing at it, and you start shooting at the other guy?
Thank you, yeah. Rough goes LeBarry for following. Welcome to the adventure.
All right. So I guess Brenna's probably leading this, with backup from Carro, while Gareth kind of like falls the ground. No, sorry, York falls the ground and is like clutching his arm. So yeah, let's get some hunt rolls, I guess, because this is pistols rather than close quarters combat.
Pistols are dawn, sir.
So 2d6 from Brenna and 2d6 take the worst one from Carro, please.
4.
Good.
Oh fuck.
That's 3. So you get the 4. You don't take stress because you only take stress from other people you have to cover for. You're just not very effective. Or maybe like the dog jumps in the way of your shot because you like you're slightly panicking because just things aren't going right. And then like you send the dog and then you don't pay enough attention to your mind link and you nearly shoot him. Oh Jesus!
It's a dog park.
Beautiful. It's perfect timing.
I love that dog.
So
the dog is barking. I love him.
I'll be right back. Okay.
Here's shotgun.
Yeah, so you both shoot, and like I think so you missed the one guy and so Barry like leaps on the other one and starts like tearing out his is Barry ever just stabbing him repeatedly
with his horn. Wrecking the guy.
Yeah. But the other guy like dodges, like ducks behind like something as the bullets fly, and then runs along and leaps out, with like sword drawn, and is then on top of you. And he is a much more accomplished hand-to-hand fighter than either of you are. So, this is he is very much just like he's handling the two of you by himself. So yeah.
Barry
is busy like
they can't get him back
repeatedly goring this stuff. So yeah, this is kind of the time for you're being forced into a skirmish here where he's just like if this guy was like a PC he'd be one of those people who can take on multiple opponents at once.
Yeah
So give me a skirmish roll. Who's leading the charge with swords drawn and who's like helping out in this?
I can help out.
Probably not me.
I mean, none of you are good at this, so,
yeah, so
it's just kind of on character who leads the charge.
I guess Malin, because he's mad. and gambles
with
his life.
You're the mighty cock.
I am the mighty cock, and I shall fell all before my dumb. Yeah.
All shall fall before your furious pecking.
All shall fall before my furious cock. Yep. And now in character, what I'm going to do is...
That's why I came back. Oh, dear.
So, 2d6, is it? That's so, right there.
Yeah, none of you have a point of skirmish, as far as I can tell.
Not a single
two. So, you're all helping, I presume, because this is a bad situation.
Yes.
Would any... So, once again, any of you can take two stress to up your dice by one, but any of you can take one stress to give Carro an extra die. Sorry, the other two of you can take one stress to give Carro an extra die, which might be useful, because you can take him from rolling 2d6 to taking the worst one to rolling 2d6 to taking the better one.
I will give up one more stress.
Okay. I will put one stress more tick on York. Brenna, you've got only the one check so far, so it might be worth you expending a little bit here.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay. So
call me.
The one to give a. So I'll take the one. So that's 2d6 for you now, Carro. Would anyone else like to spend any more stress?
Nah, I'm going to save it for the big stress, like, hype at the end.
Do bear in mind, you are, like, at 3 trauma. Like, your dreams are tortured and dark these days.
I know.
Which I think is 2 trauma? No, 2 trauma. So you've got, like, one more ability to take a deep, scarring psychological wound.
Carro's are pretty bad, too.
Okay, so yeah, that's,
A 1! The boy!
So you take the better one. So
The boy is 4!
And then... You guys both roll 2d6 and take the worst one, unless you wish to spend 2 stress to up yours.
Ah, that's okay.
Okay, that's pretty good for York. Okay, so that is a stress for Carro, because he has to compensate for,
something.
Brenna.
He's compensating for something.
You're compensating for Brenna, like, she's just there with, like, guns. Like, I don't fist fight. What? Yeah, no. Just kind of running and getting in the way. And
thank
the dog's
you.
Yapping. he's trying to help, but he seems to more be attacking you swear to God, than he is the other guy.
Thank you to Rayolin for falling. Welcome to the adventure, my friend. 3 followers off your decision. Hype.
Just a question. What does York, like, how does York throw down in a fist fight?
Just brutally, headbutts and elbows.
Okay. You fight like a Scotsman.
Yeah. complete, yeah, just using any part of his body he can.
Okay, cool. And yeah, I presume you've got your sword cane. Who is it? What's his bloody name? Arlo.
Arlo, yeah. The blade. It's mine now.
You're making a decent show of it. Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Thank you, the only Foxhound for playing. I wonder if this is Foxhound or one of his friends, because Foxhound is playing with us in the next game. But welcome to the adventure, my friend. You're a gentleman and a scholar, sir, and I will drink to your follow with another glass.
Oh my god.
I've got another... Wait, how long have I been going? Okay, we've got another 7 hours, we'll be fine.
Okay, I've just been sent a,
Nude? Yes.
No.
I hope you'd like it. I mean...
Sleeping bag.
Oh, okay.
thanks for that, Geeky. Thanks for that. Okay, so... Yes, 4 to 5, a desperate roll. There's a consequence of a severe harm or a serious complication occurs.
Shout out to Foxhound on the boys. Gonna enter the tomb of horror shortly.
So, yeah, so you're fighting, and I think basically what happens is, like, he gets briefly distracted when York runs up and, like, just tries to jump him. He manages to, like, roll York off him, spins around, and you stab him in the chest. And he kind of looks at it, looks down at the blade, looks back up at you, slides forward, and just goes to, like, brutally hack across your chest. Would you like to resist this using stress or take, like, a very debilitating wound that will put you in, like, you need physical support to do anything? Territory.
Is this me?
This is you.
Okay.
You're leading the action, so you suffer the consequences.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, you literally stabbed him, and he kind of looks up at you, and he's like, I think you see the rage essence, like, bloodshot, like, throbbing bright red in his eyes, and he like slides forward on the blade and like lifts his sword arm high and slashes down. I think the intention is to cut your arm off.
What are my choices here?
So it's either take a horrifically like painful and serious wound that will prevent you from doing basically anything without being supported by somebody. The other option is you can roll and take a boat ton of stress and see how well that works out for you.
Let's take stress.
Okay, so you would roll. Oh, yours aren't sorted, of course not, because I'm a terrible person. So this is a prowess one. Less prowess, gamut, and wreck.
Thanks for the host, Foxhound.
You do not seem to have any skills in the prowess chunk. Less prowess, gamut, and wreck. You do not. So, we roll 2d6 and you take the worst one.
Oh, brilliant. What could go wrong, boys?
Everything
could go wrong because I rolled a 1.
Oh, damn. Okay, so that takes... That gives you 5 stress.
That hurt.
Yeah, so... Yeah, so you're just about up. But yeah, you leap backwards. And the sword like smashes into the ground, and you see he like swings so hard the sword blade breaks off on the ground, and he like staggers towards you, and like you feel like death is actually coming for you at this
Barry.
And he like winds back and goes to like
you hear me, Barry,
and like just collapses in front of you, and yeah, your heart's going a mile a minute. Like it's the thing of if you have anything even slightly more stressful at this point, you're gonna have a heart attack.
The thing with Carro is he like lives off of this shit. From now, like this is how he gets his actual highs. Like this is how he gets his kick. He's like, despite him being close to death, but this is he's having a great time.
Yeah, no, this is what you
living
live
for. The dream.
He's living the dream right now, darling.
What the?
Doge. Oh.
It's a dog.
It's a dog.
So cute.
It's a dog.
I'm broken.
Done. Spent.
Okay, that's it.
That's who making all the noise. I do apologize.
I love dogs.
Cool. So yeah, you have one. You have space for one more stress before you collapse, Carro. Yeah. One second. I'm just making sure I've done this right, so I haven't given you all more stress than you need to. Okay. Actually, no. It's not even completely that you actually you do completely fine from this. I don't suppose Carro wears armor at all, does he?
Maybe right. Something underneath.
Okay. Then in which case I'll do this a little easier, because otherwise we might lose Carro as like a major player in this this session, and I don't want to do that. So you've under some advisement from other people. Maybe it's you had a sparring session with Tink, and she kicked the shit out of you, and she was like, "How about you just wear like some steel plates, and we don't have to worry about this anymore."
I guess.
So. Like, he brings this sword down, and this this armor catches it, just, like, dents it. It feels like you've been hit by a truck. He then, like, collapses and dies. And you, like, pull this thing off. It's, like, it's literally stopping you breathing until you pull it off. And, yeah, you have this, like, metal sheet, and he's, like, just dented it in, like, to the point the sword blade is wrapped in it. And you've got this wicked-looking bruise on, like, your left boob. I imagine Carro has a relatively impressive pair of moves.
He does have a great rack on.
Yeah. Oh, one of them is turning a lovely shade of black and blue. You don't take that extra stress. You are not injured. But you do not have
a nipple.
I look down, the nipple's gone.
Oh, no. Source of my power.
Quellen's just there like, oh my god.
I'm still like trying to like point my gun at him. You shut up. I may be one nipple down, but I have 3 more, and it's not gonna stop.
3 more?
Yep.
He just kind of, I don't think he even notices that you just said something completely insane. He's like, oh my god. Like, Quellen isn't used to direct violence. He kind of goes along for jobs where it's supposed to be, we get in, we get out, I do some cool ghost shit, and it's supposed to be quick and quiet and easy. He wasn't quite expecting the murder train.
It was a really...
You guys are like, lol.
All the board.
Yeah. So you that's what's going on. Do bear in mind, by the way, so Kara, you can go into fights using more like of your attune stuff. So you can like you c- so instead of going for massive lightning storms, you could maybe make like a little icicle of, like basically you could throw icicles like Zeus throws like lightning bolts and stuff like that for just like anti-personnel ones at the same magnitude as maybe a gunshot. And instead of using hunt, you're using attune, which is you have three dice in. Just so you know.
Okay. Cool.
Just if you want to use less mundane methods. That's a special thing because both you are really good at using ghost field powers, and also because you have that tempest ability.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Bafos Cuentero, for following. Welcome to the adventure, my friend. You're a gentleman and a scholar, so that puts us one off. 1,100. The next follower initiates a view decision. It could be you. Could be you.
Everyone do what Hannah's doing and tweet me pictures of your dogs. Please. Thanks, Hannah. You give me life. Your dogs give me life.
Oh, God. Oh, hey, Hannah. Cool. Yeah, so you've cleared this little place of bad guys for now, and Barry kind of pads his way over, looking very pleased with himself that he's, like, ripped the throat out of a person.
Oh my god.
Barry is just on point today. He just knows when he's needed.
I'm so sorry. It's my other one this time. I sent the other one off and the other one's come.
Oh god, I'm clicking the wrong buttons. Okay. So yeah, you've cleared the obstacles to the vault. Is there any like what's the plan now? Is it break in?
The plan here is me like minus one nipple to keep pointing at Quillen with my gun and being like, Quillen, you're getting me in there. Or I swear to God, I just get it in there, Quillen. Yeah. Because
so you get up to those like these giant big stone doors and you pull out your little little strange key that you were given by Madame Helena. Mm-hmm. And twist it in the lock and these doors like slide open, and then you're in the middle of this like dark stone, like it's kind of it's a really dark stone room, and at the center of it this giant like orb of like rock is sitting on a little plinth. So like there's this tiny ass little plinth, and on it this 10-foot in radius stone orb with like sigils drawn in electroplasm, like burning and crackling with electricity, covering it over. And Quellen's like, I think Quellen just next to you can't resist going, well, Madame Helena didn't skimp on security, it seems. So Kara, you can tell that the whatever ghostly defenses are here were agitated by exercising excessive ghost powers around the building, which you've woken it up, and this place is
Oh dear, everybody, there appears to be ghosts. Let's get everything, stuff it into bags and all my body, and go.
this thing is still sealed. This is the ghost part of security that Helena.
That's the plan once we get inside. Now, the ghost part I will deal with because I am a mastermind when it comes to this now.
And I roll up my sleeves and begin to perform my magic shit.
Cool. Give me that attune roll, please, then. And also your beautiful incantation.
Cool.
It's woken up, so this is a lot... You are not in a completely safe and dominant position right now. This is definitely difficult.
Yeah.
Give me... it's 3d6.
3d6. Let's go. 4, 4, and a 2.
4, 4, and a 2. Okay. A 4 is decent enough. So you do it. You see, like, lines of electricity start disconnecting, mm-hmm. and the black rock, like, severs along what were previously invisible joints and, like, starts peeling open. It's kind of the entire thing unfurls like a giant flower, stone moving, like, the waystone just like it flows open. And yeah, so it starts to like settle, and then you hear the doors from upstairs crash open, and the sound of like a lot of feet on the floor coming downstairs, and a voice yells, "This is the Bluecoats! Put your weapons down!"
No, we won't be doing. Don't listen to them. Listen to me.
What do you do, team? They're on their way. They're coming down like the same routes you came down. You are inside a room that can be sealed.
How many entrances are there? Just one.
To this room, only the one.
Okay, I'll rig up the door with explosives and I will attempt to cave it in.
Okay. I mean, again, there's only one entrance into this room, which also means there's only one exit from this room.
Okay, I will turn to, is it Kaelin?
It's Brenner.
Oh, Carro.
Oh, Carro.
And say, can you teleport us out of here?
Yes, maybe. Might kill me.
Yeah, I think you get a look from Quellen that's kind of like, are you insane? This room is like is supercharged with like arcane forces. You try to move into the ghost field from here, we'll get torn apart.
Okay, I will then show
Quellen,
you.
Quellen,
after you then, sir.
I say, Quellen, no one said anything about taking you.
Oh, good. I really want to be in this room when you turn it into a blender.
Well, why would you want to be in a room when I turn it into a blender? Let's just...
It's going to be nicer than where you end up.
I don't think so.
Yeah, so are you rigging the door to blow, York?
I look at the rest of the party. Is there anyone that disagrees with that?
I think...
No, I'm like, blow the bloody doors off.
Let's go.
Then rub my hands together. I've been waiting for this. And then I
only told you to blow the bloody doors off.
And I put in as much explosive as I think it needs to cave it in and stop anyone getting through.
Give me that wreck roll.
Oh, here we go, guys.
This is definitely desperate because you have significant time pressure.
A five.
Five is good. A five is good. Okay. So yeah, you rig it, and I think it's... So, Quellen kind of runs over as you're, like, putting light to touch paper and goes, no, you're gonna trap us all, we're gonna die in here! And, like, I think Brenner maybe just shoves him off, and he lands and cracks his head against the, one of the big bits of black stone. There's, like, unfold out like a giant-ass petal. And then you can turn... And it's like hallway and doors just cave in, and the sound of like a lot more screaming can be very briefly heard before this entire thing falls in, and you are cut off from the rest of the building and trapped in this little sarcophagus room.
Excellent work.
I like to think I'm just laughing maniacally the whole time this is happening.
So the black orb is unfurled, and inside, there's just like piles and piles of money. Like each of these petal things just has like. Bags, like small bags that contain huge amounts of coins strapped to them. There's a lot of wealth in here. You're robbing an entire casino blind. Also, like a few things of like security for a sort of like large loans. Like people don't carry that much cash, so like people will give wealth like fancy possessions and it's like here's something really nice. Just trust I can pay.
Finbar. I need to thank a man called Poyle 12345 for following. You know what that means, Finbar.
Does that... Are we there? Is it that time?
Viewer decision, boys! Alright, boys, everybody, get in your decisions. Okay, so if you're new, you haven't experienced this before, what happens is you guys can suggest anything which happens next in our adventure. It could be literally anything you decide, and then you get to vote, and it will put it up in a straw poll and post it in chat. So throw in suggestions, and I will put them into a little cheeky straw poll for you, boys.
Can I make a suggestion for this?
You may.
Can one of them be the return of Animus Vampire Skirtlock?
Lose Finbar, then.
I feel that needs to be on the list.
Ben, I just lost here for.
Oh, sorry. So the return of Animus Vampire Skirtlock, and all his like lightning bolt throwing Carro hating nurse.
Yes. Oh, thank you to the Spartan Show for falling. Welcome to the adventure. Mitch, could I ask you to do the straw poll for me, mate?
Oh, dear. So I'll wait while they're working. While they're working on that, we'll discuss just what you're doing in this room, what you're bagging the treasure into, and all that jazz. Are you trying to take every goddamn cent?
Oh yeah, I'm taking all cool.
Okay, so yeah, like, what is next? How do you get all this out? What are people doing?
I think the viewer decision should be that we somehow.
Just
get it all.
The viewer decision is that you magically had giant ass bags filled with.
We grew extra arms, and we're able to carry it.
Oh dear. Yes. Do we have any good suggestions yet in the chat?
Yeah. Okay. Mitch doesn't know how to do it, but I think and I believe in you, Mitch. Strawpoll.me. You're on it, mate. Good idea.
This thing unfurls and it has lots of
Giant ghost of a Leviathan starts rampaging through the city, drawn to the party in the casino. Spontaneous combustion kills Elphoy. No. Quellen morphs into a wraith that encompasses half the room. Nice one, Ghostly. Barry grows wings. Ah, that's Sydney. My suggestion is that all the player non-characters become dogs and the Elphoy's game contingent. I like that. I like that, Foxhound. Maybe that should happen when you play, mate. Will remembers he has a bag of holding. Yes. Mitch is like absolutely on point.
Oh dear.
I need to add that follower. Good job to Spartan Show. Welcome, mate, to the chat. So, yeah, and if you guys haven't seen our giveaway yet, Sword Coast Adventurer's Guide up in the top right, you can go and grab yourself a copy of that, the new book out. I vote for whatever character Will is playing. What? I don't want to read that.
No, you
I mean,
don't.
If just you like, if you want to see that, yeah. Then come to our private Skype sessions.
D&D after dark.
Yeah, D&D and chill when Finwell comes over.
Yeah,
I'm like, "Bae, come over."
That's that. We call that rolling dirty. It's our it's our triple X show. Can't even stream on Twitch.
Wow. I'm gonna briefly take a rest break. It's been another 3 hours since I had one. So, guys, chat to people. Don't let your dreams memes be memes. I'll be right back. And there's a dog, so there you go.
Dogs. All the dogs. Oh dear. Oh dear, that thing's adorable.
She was
Why have you done this?
She's a kid. Hello.
What's the dog called?
This is Tilly.
Looks just like Will.
Sorry, my Skype is telling me that apparently I've
Tilly, please don't take out my headphones.
No, Tilly, why? How could you betray us like this, dog? Oh dear.
Tilly goes back to sleep.
Paul has arrived.
She just like.
Going
back to bed.
Something about the original Power Rangers turning up.
We don't know these new fancy Power Rangers.
Yeah, of course.
Does that include the White Ranger? Was he
Is it Green Ranger? Is it White Ranger? These are the questions.
Yeah.
And then is it post when they get like ninja outfits that they use randomly, or is it after ninja outfits? God, that show. Power Rangers. Just brief aside from it, Power Rangers is an insane concept for a show or a studio. Where you know what we should do? We should take a Japanese TV show. Then hire a bunch of American actors, take their action scenes where they're in superhero suits, and then have different scenes where our characters are doing things in their real life, and cut it together.
Didn't they change one of the sexes of the Rangers as well? Wasn't like the Pink Ranger actually a man in Japan?
I don't know about that. I know they also, to cut costs later on down the line, they film all of the Power Rangers stuff that they do for art networks over here in New Zealand, because it's way cheaper. But because they're still pretending it's American, everyone has to try and do an American accent, most of which are terrible. And there was one guy whose accent was so bad, they just went, you're just a New Zealand guy living in America. and geez, Power Rangers. Not to mention one season, like, was about, because they didn't tell them very far in advance what the thing was about. So, like, the American one got about a season and, like, a good, like, had halfway filmed Power Rangers in space. This entire space-themed thing for their scenes, and then got a bunch of stuff that was like,
I'm back.
Here's a completely different show. It's about toys and the internet. It's all virtual reality.
Stropo boys.
Oh, I know. All parties going extra. Ours, a pack of wild corgis attacked. Dragons and attack. Yeah.
I like the arms.
Oh, good God.
This is the first time something I've suggested has made it on to the Astropole.
Proud moment.
I made a choice not to vote for come up with anything today, just in case.
you know yourself too well. You might you might create something terrible.
Yeah.
Might.
Oh dear. We've got 22 votes in the results so far.
Yeah, he's Mitch's.
Yeah.
Alright, I need to go and tweet.
Alright. Are we tweeting this out?
Yeah, I'm gonna tweet you out. When Bay tweets you out.
I think someone must have taken Tilly on a walk, like, instead of letting me do it, because she's dirty, so that means someone let her roll around in dirt, because they're a bad parent.
I don't wonder who that was.
Bet it was Greg.
Fucking Greg every time.
Every time.
I try and tell him. Does he listen?
No.
No, he doesn't. Alright.
Oop! Let me do that. Oh, dear. Oh, no.
What have you done? I see an undead baron. How's it going, dude? Both the arms.
For the arms. Hell yeah. Squad up.
Squad boys.
The dogs and arms are like real neck popular neck. Decisions. I want giant ghost leviathan. That's what I'm pumping for. Space whales. It's gonna be that scene out of Metal Gear Solid 5, just flaming space whales.
Whales with wings is what I'm thinking of.
No, there's no obvious flight mechanism. It's just a flying whale. fuck your physics. This whale can fly. How dare you?
You
don't. They try to contain me with such basic ideas.
Oh, we're pretty tied up. All NPCs become dogs and all parties members grow extra arms.
Those two have...
Please let it be arms.
All right, Hannah. See you soon. We've got another, 19 hours to go, so there is quite a lot of it left. See you later, boys.
See you, Hannah.
Bye.
Nice come by.
Ah, morning, Baron. Good to see you.
Greetings, Baron. You should vote in our straw poll, even though you have no context for anything. But frankly, you don't need context to know whether you should turn a party into dogs.
Yeah, but no context is required for such a decision.
Arms! Arms!
Correct. Arms. How's it going, Keith? Tomb of Horrors is after this is in 1 hour, Poi Poi. Good to see you, buddy. I know you're going to enjoy that one. Poi Poi has been waiting for a lot of death. Yeah. For a long time.
I don't know how you do this, Will. I'm tired after 5 hours.
Yeah, mate. It's the alcohol, kind of. I'm currently on like a buzzing from the
alcohol a little bit. It does help. I mean, I don't know if it's necessarily the wise choice at
silence.
5 o'clock when you've got to be up for another 7 hours minimum. I presume you're swapping over with Myth at the midway point. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good luck keeping up that pace of alcohol for 7 more hours.
Honestly, like it's very doable.
For me. Also being on stream.
Yeah,
it's true. A combination of factors that might do some interesting things to yourself.
I do, the thing is, like, I tend to just drink for a long amount of time and then just be fairly drunk for all of it rather than dying.
That's good.
So, yeah. I mean, Sydney, you can testify the amount of times I come back and I've been very drunk.
Yeah.
But I have lived.
There is nothing classier than drinking vodka out of a mug, though.
Thank you. It's my trademark.
On my Snowocalypse show, one of my players, Chip, regularly drinks wine out of a carton. Not a box!
That's Chip for
like
you.
It's like an orange juice carton.
How does she get it into the carton?
Like Ribena cartons of wine.
As really? Does Super Basics.
That is a classic student thing to do.
Yeah.
Bagels, Will. I don't know what you're talking about, Mitch. That sounds very Canadian. Right.
Bagels?
Bagels, I know what they are, mate. Okay, so we have 9 votes into all members. Party members grow extra arms. We've got 30 votes. Are we happy to go with that one?
Arms? Sure, yeah. Arms.
Hell yes!
Arms.
Oh, I scared my dog, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so,
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, so I think you blow this roof, and then you turn around like, yeah!
Blow the roof off.
And just in time to see, like, Quellen's, like, mouth and eyes both pop open and, like, glowing from the inside with, like, a bright green light.
Not again,
Quellen. His body kind of, like, jerks upwards, and these, he's like, blasts of kind of weirdly like sparkly green fire like shoot out of his body, and like with like it kind of looks like Death Coil from Warcraft 3, and hit you all, including Barry the dog, and yeah, so from
excuse me,
you fucking what?
And yeah, so let's see. So I think Carro, you get like the most awkward one of a second, like another arm. Like first of all, these like you get this weird like wriggling of your flesh here.
Does it come out of my nipple?
Fingers peel off from your nipple, not nipple. nipple, and then just like shoots out like an arm like there out of the like.
You said
of,
nipple.
Like,
I'm taking
yeah, no,
nipple.
I said, yeah, so out of your like chest from the gap in your like shirt where you got slashed with a sword. So for York, it's from his elbow, like these fingers peel off, and then yeah, you get like two arms, like two forearms to one bicep, just kind of like, so you now no longer really take as much of a difficulty from having one fucked up arm with a bullet in it, because you've got two arms there, and yeah, I think, so Barry, like a hand just like grows out of the back of his out of his back, just kind of like waves. So you got like dog and just a hand is like, hi.
Could have multiple uses.
Yeah.
Give him a gun.
It's it's a dog hand, Carro. Because dogs have hands.
Of course, like
you racist, Will. How dare you?
Oh my god.
Yeah, and then
does my dog have a paw on his back or a hand?
It's a hand. It's a human hand.
You want to delay, Sydney?
Yeah, because we did just have this conversation.
Wait, what?
What? Dog has a human hand on its back.
Okay.
And breathe. And Brenna
and drink.
What?
Where does Brenna's extra arm sprout from?
What?
You know, it's from the small of your back. Just this arm just like rips through the back and like kind of wriggles up out of your like your shirt collar, just like yeah, just like round, like kind of coming at the base, at like the top of your spine almost is where this jaw. You have your third shoulder. Yeah. You all have three arms now, and the dog has a hand. Yeah, Carro, you're just like, ghost mutations aren't usually that fast. You swear this hasn't actually happened?
This never happens, honestly. I honestly, Brenna, this never happens. I can fix this. Definitely, I can fix this if, let me get my bone saw.
I kind of like it. I think it adds to the...
It does have multiple uses, I suppose.
It comes in handy.
A ghost appears and slaps you all.
Each of you just gets slapped by ghosts.
No. Oh my god. Call to your immediate problem, however, other than body horrific morphing, you are trapped underground. A contained room, so his body is now still like. You look over to Quellen, and he has sprouted additional arms, legs, just assorted things.
Oh, Quellen, like, every time.
Yeah, he does not appear to be reacting well to having his head cracked open on Ghost Rock.
Ghost Rock.
Yeah, and so you're trapped in this confined room with a thing that just mutated and gave you all a third arm. And does seem to be going, it turning into some eldritch horror right now.
Okay, look, this is good. Look, we have three arms, that means one third extra amount of gold that we can carry out of here. So everyone, grab what you can, and I'll teleport us out of here somehow without possibly turning us into living blenders. But,
perfect.
First of all, we'll grab all the money you can.
I would take my trousers off, I'll knot the legs, and I'll just start piling in cash into the little bag that I've made.
Thank you to Mac858 for falling welcome to the adventure, my friend. You've chosen an excellent moment to join the adventure.
Have we just hit music?
Hmm?
Hit music.
You should.
Did you turn on music?
No, I didn't.
I don't hear music.
Do you smell toast? Are you okay, Finbar? Finbar, talk to me. I hear voices now. Are you listening to the stream?
Sounds like kind of creepy, like, mood music. Coming from somewhere. I don't know where.
Coming from my mind.
Okay, so... Really, this disturbing. I feel like I'm in a horror film right now. Okay, yeah, so,
Welcome, mortal.
So, yeah, you kind of start gathering, like, are all of you doing the trouser trick, and just, you've all worn high-capacity trousers.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of...
pants you wear to a buffet.
There's a lot of room in there.
Is there any, like, nice jewellery? Because I'll put that on. I could have three watches on.
Yeah,
now
there's definitely a few, like, fancy pocket watches, necklaces and noble family heirloom necklaces, things like that, to kind of act as security.
Yeah, I want to look like a three-armed rapper with no trousers on. That's what I'm going for.
Good. This is going to be very strong. So you start losing. Carro, Krellin's body is still like twisting at unnatural angles, and sparks are coming off of it. And a man of your esteemed academic understanding of the weird knows that that's fucking bad. Like, demon mutation is not supposed to be this quick.
This isn't good news, but I keep that to myself. So have we grabbed, like, loads of shit by now?
Yeah, you've definitely, like, picked up a fairly large amount of cash.
And then I say, Barry, Le Cavity.
Looks towards you, and the hand just waves, like...
Oh, the hand goes down, like...
Wait, have we got a self-loading dog? I'm broken.
He's so broken.
Self-loading dog.
Oh my god.
Oh god.
Tears, guys. Actual tears.
Welcome, Blaze the Dark. A totally serious game about crime in Victorian weirdo London. Oh god. Okay.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Everyone
it's
just
great.
Made like a. Oh, like a.
Yes. Okay, so you have all removed your trousers and started tied them at the bottom, started loading them with money, and Carro has suggested filling the dog with gold.
Plan.
If you keep saying it, I'll keep laughing.
And yeah, there's a giant twitching eldritch horror falling in the corner of the room. With, like, sparks coming off of it.
Should we worry about him? Pointing at the eldritch horror that is...
At this point, like, there's no, like, face or, like, all of the limbs are, like, stretching out into just, like... So it looks like one really long arm with another arm then coming out of the palm and then another arm... And, like, his entire body is morphing into limbs and getting longer and wavier and kind of curling in on itself and, like... Sparks of this kind of like greenish lightning and stuff can be seen in the middle of this twisty up ball of grossness.
Oh dear! I say, come here, everyone. Form a huddle, form a circle. Hold my hand, not my donga. My hand, I said, Barry.
Dog leaps up and just like grabs onto your freshly formed like pinky finger with his teeth.
Okay, pinky promise, fine. Now, hold my hand, my hands, all three of them.
You've got a hand each.
Yeah, that's quite good, actually. That's pretty handy.
Fuck off.
Fuck off your own stream. I'm done.
Just leave. I guess this is you attempt to attune to the ghost field.
Okay, I'm back, I'm sorry.
To, like, open a...
Yeah, I'm gonna, like...
death itself.
I'm gonna teleport our bodies.
Yeah,
through the death.
Yeah, this is definitely a desperate situation.
To the death.
The ghost field is like, as your brain starts to tune into it, this, like, standing next to whatever the hell Quillen is becoming is the equivalent of, like, imagine standing in a kitchen with, like, 10 blenders plugged in, and all of them get switched on, and then you're desperately trying to listen to an iPod at half volume with only one headphone. And it's a matter of life or death that you make out every single word. So yeah, roll those dice, and don't fuck up.
So it's 3d6.
Yep, unless you want to take stress.
I don't think I physically can.
Oh no, you're okay because we you have armor.
Oh, good roll.
Good roll, old chap. Jolly good roll.
Good.
You have arm.
Jesus Christ.
Wait, what are we rolling?
So, no, you're fine. So Carro kind of opens his brain. No, I'm not pockets. Well, doesn't
it's not
open
the
brain.
Only thing I've opened recently, isn't that right, Barry?
There's a thunder crack and you appear outside the casino. And you see a couple of, like, the wagons that, like, the carriages and wagons that have, like, the blue coats are pulled up in. There's only, like, one, like, the drivers nearby as you, like, land. And these, like, sets of trousers. So you're all there, naked from the waist down, as these sets of, like, money-filled trousers fall and hit the ground. And you all look like genetic aberrations right now.
Perfect.
And, yeah, so you land, and, like, this like, lightning-sparking void in the air starts to, like, close. And then start sparking again, Carro. And you see a palm push out through it that's then followed by like three more hands, like start pulling it wider and more hands start coming through. You are being pursued. And
we're being pursued quickly, everyone, on all three hands. Barry, run.
Barry can like use his extra hand to like help scoop him along, like on the.
It's on the wrong side. Have to like run.
No, it's like
side flip and then like flick along. Oh
no, he can turn on his head and just bounce on that one.
He's patting his own backside like a jockey.
Good boy. Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
Oh my good god. Yeah, like I think so. One of the drivers like turns around and like you see him start to yell and wave his hand in the air towards the house. So is the plan to just fucking leg it straight into the city and try and get back to base, or have you got like a different escape route plan that might be a little more covert?
The whale.
Last time I like rode a
giant
whale.
You want to try and hell a leviathan to come assist you. You want to bring more weird ghost shit down on this.
Yeah, it's my friend because we had that relationship. Like
he found you funny.
Yeah, he found me funny. Yeah, yeah.
That's like, okay. Yeah. That's give me another attune roll.
That's like
run to the waterfront and throw your arms up.
It's like me. Like we had a relationship. She found me vaguely funny.
Yeah, it's gonna go great.
Not the same thing.
Give me another tune roll. Give me a man after midnight.
Give me a whale after Barry's dong is. Okay, don't know where that was going. A 4, a 2, and a 6.
Yeah, so you reach out. Did we give him a name? This giant.
If we did, I do not remember it.
Okay.
Nothing to do with drink.
Do, let me look.
I
don't think we did, no.
I don't think we did.
Yeah, so...
I'm sure chat will come up with something.
Should we let chat name it?
Sure. What is... Yeah, what is the name of this this creature? And, like, you reach out through the ghost field, and I think, at this point, Brenner, you turn around, like, the hands, like, landing on the floor and, like, flopping grossly and wetly and spreading out to, like... To that point, like, six arms are there. They will start dragging Quellen's disturbed form through this hole in space. It's the dog of Pomeranian. Get out. Get out. Leave. You are the worst.
That is the sound that Ren made. Way! When he... After he made that joke. And then there was
Dandelion?
A shotgun.
Dandelion is good.
Mrs. Super Unnecessarily Long Name.
Levi Sean.
Fire Shawn.
Dave's solid. Dave is pretty good.
Oh my god. yeah, I think
it's a Palmer Doodle.
It's
like,
Palmer Doodle. I love it.
God. So yeah, I think it's like you get the sound of like. So maybe like you had like another conversation with it. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Dreams reached out to it, and you asked its name at one point, and it's like, in my, you are not capable of speaking, forming the sounds required to say. It like mutters some alien complex noises at you.
I'll just call you.
They refer to me as Dave.
Dave, that's just
the name I had in mind. That weird like Dave. Sound of like granite moving that happens when it talks. Crackin' lackin'.
like dog that. Meat.
Someone's been playing too much Fallout.
Oh dear, that's so good though. So you see like the kind of a massive bulge form in the midnight sea on the other side of the electro fences.
Crazy.
Rapidly approaches like building looking like a tsunami. Yeah, okay, bulge. It's hilarious.
We're seven.
And I think Dave's voice booms within your mind, Karis, like what foul horrors have you brought upon yourself this time, you fool? And then this massive wave hits one of the lightning fences.
Mm-hmm.
And goes, and like its voice kind of like shrieks in pain, and it's like, if you wish for my assistance, little man, you're going to need to let me in. I don't know how you plan to take down a lightning fence in one go.
I have no idea how you plan to enter me, but
it's trapped. Like there's this giant water wall to the city. That like, by the way, so there's one thing to like wreck a few buildings in a poor district. Like what you're doing is basically saying, you know what we don't need right now? Town walls. That's your plan. And like not just town walls to keep out invaders, town walls to keep out giant demon monsters that are very, very real. You're the guy who's like, you know what we should do? We should put a giant dragon's free food here sign in the town.
That's me.
In Skyrim.
I'm that guy.
So he's like, basically, he wants you to do something to hit this thing from the inside so that he can get in.
Someone stole your sweet roll.
I'm like, how do I let you in, almighty Dave?
You're a being of some knowledge of the manipulating electroplasm. Create some form of...
Yes, I am.
Destruction. Destroy this pylon. And like, I think in your mind, it's like, you kind of, it overlays your vision with his.
Everybody, like, pile on!
Everyone, get in! the big parts of the electric, sending out, like, out in the ocean, like, the bits of the Thames barrier, like, these giant-ass things that have, like, lightning bolts constantly streaking between them. And I think his basic gist is, yo, use crazy bullshit magic powers and knock them over. Meanwhile, Brenner and...
I'm gonna do that.
Brenner, so you'll start to build up towards, I guess it's time for a storm. Brenner and York, while he's building, you've got the slight issue of a giant eldritch horror is, like, nearly on top of you, and is, like, trying to, like, reaching for Carro with assorted many arms and limbs. What do you do?
We should start chopping off his limbs.
That sounds like a solid plan.
Yeah.
Okay, so I imagine one hand I'm holding up one of these black orchids to my face, breathing it in. And then my other hands, I'm just going to chuck something, possibly acid or something, to dissolve it.
Okay, I will give you the rec on that then, because I'm nice like that.
Welcome.
Thank you, Jacob Extreme, for being welcome to Live Edge, my friend. You're a gentleman. And a scholar, sir.
Okay, that's pretty good. Brenner, are you backing this up with swords or pistols or what?
Yeah, I want swords, and I want to like windmill all my arms to just and go towards it, just
all
like
of them.
Swinging.
All three.
You like your third arm like flicks out and grabs the sword cane. You pull out two little knives. You're just like.
I'm doing like a majorette routine.
Uh-huh.
This is technically my fourth arm, but never mind.
Huh. Did that turn you on, Finbar? Because was that what that was?
No, that was not.
Was that what that was?
No, it was the other one.
Oh.
Distinctly disturbed. Yeah, okay, hand so give hand. Me give me a skirmish then, Brenna. Which is 2d6, take the lower.
Oh,
yeah. Charming. See how well you guys do.
Six and a
Damn!
Six.
Nice.
So that is a double six, so you crit it, so that this thing, like, is, like, pulling itself forward, and you see, like, what is left of, like, so there's, like, the eye, like, here, and to here, there's, like, still Quellen's, like, eyes staring out for the little of this, like, back of this, like, assorted tentacles made of arms, and then, like, the bottom of his face is just turned into fingers. It looks a bit like Davy Jones, but less squid-like. And, yeah, the arms, like, reach out and try to, like, grab you. And, yeah, so you kind of, like, spin around each other where you chop an arm off and it starts to regrow, and then York is there, like, throwing acid on it till it burns and cauterizes. And you manage to hold back this tide of, like, arms coming in and push it back a bit. And you see on the other side, Bluecoats are, like, arriving on, like, Bluecoats and Spirit Wardens in, like, the Bluecoats obviously dressed in their blue and, like, swords and guns coming out, and the Spirit Wardens with their lightning hooks and like, pristine white coats. And they start throwing, like, these lightning bolts start shooting off into the chunk of Quellen's body, and it, like, twists and then starts, like, leaping towards them. And you see what happens when these tentacles get a hold of one of the blue coats. You see, like, two of them pick one of these things up by both of his arms, and the third one grabs, like, third and fourth grab, like, both sides of his jaw and start pulling, and it just gets very, very graphic very fast. And so, yeah, it loses some attention on you because you're too difficult a meal. So, Carro, throw some storm. You are on 2 stress, so you can feasibly take 6 stress and collapse, or 5 stress and not.
I'll take 5.
Okay.
Because YOLO, boys.
Give me that that attune, then.
Can I get a YOLO, boys, in chat? A 5, a 6, and a 4. Thank you, Cam, the gamer, for following. Welcome to the adventure, my friend.
So, yeah, you've definitely got the magnitude down here because you just spent 5 stress on this thing.
Cam, the gamer, you're an internet hobo.
So...
chat made me do it.
Tell me what this one looks like. Like, are you just going for, like, lightning bolts on this thing, or are you,
Oh, I'm going fucking storm.
Okay. So, yeah, like... so I think maybe, like... You're like, I just, like, held off an eldritch beast. That's pretty cool. You turn around, and then it's just, like, green lightning and clouds pouring out of Caro's, like, arms. And he's just, like, coagulating his jaws.
Yeah, Kalima. Thank you, AP Gaming.
Are we on the right side of this? And so, like, these two normal arms, like, slowly rotating, and, like, these clouds and lightning bolts pouring off of them. And the one in the middle, like, coming out of his chest, just kind of fanning it. Just yeah, this massive storm cloud floats out over the bay. And in your voice, in your head, Dave's voice kind of booms, like, excellent, little Carro. You never cease to amuse.
Not so little, I've actually grown a little bit since you last met me.
I can sense that. We'll discuss in a moment. And yeah,
you met my third arm, but this is my fourth.
Yeah, the thing winds back and you see these two giant stone arms, like, peel off of the side of this huge kind of, like, red veiny whale creature floating out in the bay. And it, like, charges once again and grabs at this pylon, and the lightning starts arcing down its arms. And the big cloud forms and starts, like, you just see, like, not so hail is an underrating of how big these things are. It's, like, full-on ice spears and lightning bolts smashing off the fences, and the lightning fences start, like, juddering as green lightning starts shooting through the blue. And then it just rips this fucking pylon out of the sea and shreds it apart. And yeah, then speeds towards the dock.
Dock with me, Dave.
Yeah, you see the sounds of Bluecoats, like, screaming in the background. And Dave kind of slows down, and this arm, like, just smashes into the dock side.
Dave,
and,
like, you throwing mock the week.
Only English people get that one.
All he has is Top Gear. Really.
He's got Top Gear and Mock the Week is all he plays.
Gary Clarkson's riding on his back.
The biggest whale in the world.
Like, we must be quick, friends. I am in a race with my fellow Leviathan Jerry to get to the other
Richard
side.
Hammond is coming here on a bicycle. And Captain Slow's coming in.
It's all funny till he spews some racist abuse.
No, he's gonna punch you for not giving him a steak. Yeah.
Just English things, don't worry about it, chat.
Slams down and like carves through the side of this dock like butter. And the bit of ground you're all standing on just gets scooped up. And it's good to see you're experimenting now with turning your fellow man into horrendous creatures, Carro. Greetings, new little ones. Always a pleasure to make new friends.
Everybody, this is Dave, my good friend, sometimes lover.
You're a rather veiny whale.
I think, you know, being this close to a Leviathan is like being close to Satan. And it is weird that he is friends with Satan. Oh, well, half Satan, half a nuclear bomb. Yeah.
The best combination.
By curtsy.
Nuclear Satan. And you have no trousers as well. So, it's just like, you know, you got this like shirt that's like shredded up from your assorted like close encounters with swords recently. And just like, I imagine that York wears like a pair of like wife fronts that have been around for too long in his hobo days. And just kind of like curtsies, like, quite.
My blubber lover. Very good, Rem.
God.
Rem is on point today.
Yeah, so Dave kind of chuckles like rather low and he it's like, you've done some interesting things today, Carro. I don't know if you realize how much you've just annoyed some people. I'm very excited to see how you...
Oh, Dave, don't worry. We'll always get through it. And if all else fails, I'll join you on the little island that we have to the south.
There's a sound of, like, granite.
Sound of the breeze.
Granite as it kind of chuckles. I think it's like... I think maybe, like, Brenna, you lean over and you see, like, a few more hands have, like, peeled off the sides and, like, are building themselves out of flesh and, like, picking bits and, like, people and boxes, like, bits of stuff off the side of the dock as he swims past. The stuff is just getting thrown into the city and the people are, like, being drawn back into the whale's body. This is, like, a weird kidnapping run for this giant demon thing. You're bad people, just so you know. Like, super bad people.
Thank you.
Like, the worst.
We try.
You just unleashed a genocide monster on a town.
Are we, like, riding Dave?
It's kind of carrying you.
Uh-huh.
Damn,
so many blowholes. Okay.
I'm just going to be humming Ride of the Valkyries as we
fly over
the top. I was going to
be singing A Whole New World.
That shows the complete differences in our characters, though.
Neither in tune or in time. Yeah,
I just wanna make love to you. That's what Carro said.
So he carries you away down the coastline and I guess lets you off in as discreetly as he physically can. It's not exactly a subtle escape mechanism. Give me a team prowl to try and, like, not be noticed as, like, not a member of the panicking crowd. or do you just kill everyone else there? Those are your two options.
We're, like, riding a... Wait, are we still riding the giant whale?
Yeah, no, so the giant whale kind of needs to put you down or take you out of the city. So.
Okay, I turn to the group and I say, do we want to go back to the city or do we want to go to a little... island that me and Dave have. It's a nice little place, small sauna on the side, a couple of tequilas. We could have, little sunbathing session maybe, or we could go back to the city to inevitable doom, which is soon to be upon the city.
Yeah, by the way, there's still the giant bass rumblings of a huge ass thunderstorm going behind you that Carro has completely lost control of now.
Yeah, I've just forgotten about that. There's probably some bad weather back there, but thank you, Silver K29, for following. Welcome to the adventure, my friend.
I'll look at one of my many watches. Hello, mate. I've got nothing planned.
Got nothing but time.
Oh god, that one hurt.
I'm good with the island. I mean, I
okay. The problem with the problem with the island is I was lying about it. So,
all right. Then.
What's actually gonna happen is we're gonna have to go back to the City of Doom. Okay.
City is just steadily getting.
It's just like covered in this lightning storm, yeah. Like ghosts attacking it. Like, but there's this little island. Actually, no, there's not.
No. Okay. Yeah. So he's like, Dave kind of like swings towards a dock near to like as close as he could physically get you without just piling into the city.
Pile on.
I can't not. I just can't not.
Yeah. So. It's like you're gonna land with a bunch of people, amongst a bunch of people, and like maybe having witnesses see you or dismount a giant demon whale isn't what you need as a reputation. So is like, are you trying to be subtle and blend in with the panicking crowds, or are you like fuck it and just murder the witnesses? Or some other option I haven't thought of.
We all have extra arms. I don't think we're gonna blend in.
True.
That well.
True. I say, we're all like trying to. At first, we're trying to be really inconspicuous, and everyone gives us like weird looks. We got this third arm like clawing at my face.
And we're like, what? And then our other arm comes.
Yeah,
in.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
what? Are you doing?
What?
Sorry.
You got a 3-point shrug.
What? Cool. Yeah. And then we're like, oh, fuck it. And then. Pull out pistols and swords and
lots of blowing people away. Give me a team hunt led by
I think I'm gonna say team hug. Give me a team hug. Okay, everyone, let's team hug first.
With 1.5 times the usual affection.
Wow, that's pretty coming on to me strongly.
They got another arm to hug with.
I have absolutely no hunt.
I require a hug of 1.5 times the usual affection.
For Brenner, 1d and 2d6 to take the worst one for the other two of you.
Oh, that's okay.
The boys! The 2-1.
Stress for Brenner, but you are in no way in. Like, you do pretty well. A couple people get away, but there's mostly panic. So they'll just know there's weird freaks with three arms that did this, not necessarily your specific identities. But the majority of harmless bystanders are successfully murdered or abducted by Dave. You've covered your tracks in any way a D&D party can. Dave's arms just kind of snake out and start picking up corpses and dragging them into its fleshy folds.
Classic Dave.
And yeah, you leg it back.
He'll be showing them those same shows in 10 years' time, honestly. Let's go back to the mighty cockroach.
He doesn't eat these people. They're like, their brains are networked into a thing that just comes up with old sitcoms.
Yeah.
Just, used as just processes like Last of the Summer Wine. He's actually writing like seasons 25 of Last of the Summer Wine.
I'm like, okay, let's head back to the mighty cock roost. Everybody, just back in to the hen pen. And, make it back to HQ, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, you successfully make it home, with a crap ton of money. And also, you know, possibly having dismantled the economy you could spend it in.
That is true. Yeah. But we had a good time.
Watches and jewelry.
That's all that matters.
Did everybody have a good time? Well, that's all that matters then.
The real journey was the friends you made along the way.
The arms you grew.
It's the arms you grew. And the berries that you...
Oh, dear.
Perverted.
Right. So, we've kind of finished the job at this point.
What does Lady Helena say, though?
I mean, she's like kind of lost in panic.
Can we like meet her?
Sure. So maybe like a couple days go by, and the city kind of holds its breath, waiting for
Carro to like, fuck something else up.
Kind of the consequences right, of like when are all of the Leviathans going to arrive to eat everyone? / all of the ghosts get in? / out? / just death.
So much death.
The storm was kind of blown away. I think a report came in on the paper of how it's arrived in what's it called, Skovland, that this giant like green lightning storm has blown into Skovland.
What can men do against such reckless Dave? Thank you to Squeaky Elobo for the host. Cheers, buddy.
Madame Helena meets, I guess, you in a bar at a predetermined thing, and she seems really nervous. Like, I wasn't quite expecting. Actually, no, she does this like. Today, the last few
it days, went excellently, didn't it? Yes, I know.
Do you have any way to conceal your third arm in public, Carro?
We're in a bar, right?
I mean, unless you want to specifically tell her where your hideout is.
I did just make a gigantic hand gesture, so yeah. Probably, like, I've, like, tied it to my hand, like, my arm for the moment, just, for, like, for this conversation, but for the most part, I'm doing loads of things. I'm playing, like, two instruments at once. Yeah,
you're great. Training yourselves to come tridextrous.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Good. Yeah, okay, so, yeah, you meet her in a predetermined location.
Yeah, like, in a bar or something.
What do you say?
Yeah, I say... My lady, everything went according to plan and absolutely excellently.
She kind of gives you a look like... really?
Yes, it did.
Did you have anything to do with...
No, I did not have anything to do with a gigantic storm and every consequence which happened afterwards. No, I did not. However, I did have everything to do with getting back your capital and your casino.
It's... My casino was apparently the site of the birth of an ungodly hell creature.
Yes, we torpedoed your casino to make way for some gaudy monstrosity.
Thank you, suddenly ducks you, for the host.
Do you lay down the plans for the Bellagio Hotel?
I do. Oh my god, I need to watch that film now.
I have it on DVD.
The Bellagio, the MGM Grand.
Throw down this giant piece of paper, unfurl it, and the bee on the first page.
Torpedoed my casino.
Oh god.
And blow it all up, make way for some gaudy monstrosity.
That's what the next 2 hours of the stream's gonna be.
It's gonna be me quoting. Ocean's 11. Not even watching it, just quoting random lines.
We'll react to Ocean's 11.
We'll react to Ocean's 11. Ink.
It's like that's the big joke of this entire stream. All this was leading up to, we're cancelling the next 3 hours.
No, it's all done.
Willow's just gonna watch Ocean's 11, 12, and 13, and it's actually the rest of the stream, and just tell you about how much he loves those movies.
Yeah, I have all three on DVD, but
yeah, this is why I date you. Like, huh? You didn't. This is why I date you. Ocean's 11, hi.
Oh dear.
But yeah, anyway, back in character.
So we can actually do a little thing in the last like 15 minutes of okay. So there's a thing called downtime when
ooh.
So a few things happen after you get your
it's just we all feel bad about ourselves.
A few things happen after you kind of finish a job. One, you get a crap ton of money. So you currently have about 10 coin. This is the abstract method of storing currency. So I'll give you like 12, but you can't store 12 safely. Like, it's like having tens of thousands of pounds lying around in pound coins. So it kind of needs, and it's all very like, some of the money is like tagged with like electroplasmic energies and things like that. It kind of needs to go. And also you might need a fence to get rid of the fancy jewelry. But yeah, so you get a bunch of money. And then we get to roll some dice and see how terrible things are. So we first work out heat. I'm supposed to assign heat to you based upon like how public and things. So if it was smooth and quiet with low exposure, you only get the 1. Whereas you get 6 if it was wild with devastating exposure. So I don't think there's a way for me to give you 7.
So probably a 2.
So it's add +1 heat for a... After a school conflict, the crew takes heat. Add +1 heat for a high-profile or well-connected target. Add +1 heat. It's just so everyone, you've pissed off everyone with what you just did. +1 heat for situation happened on hostile turf. Yes, because it happened on all of the turf. You just declared war with between the city and demon kind. And +1 heat if you're at war. Maybe not. And +2 heat if killing was involved. Yes. So I think definitely we're up to the 6, maybe 7 or 8 heat. Things are terrible.
Thank you, Utsuko, for following. Welcome.
Okay.
Sorry to interrupt you, Finn.
That's fine, don't worry. Okay, who wants to roll some D6s and see what terrible things happen?
I do.
Okay. let me just make sure I know exactly how many dice are supposed to be rolling. You rolled it.
Hello, Destination Valhalla. I'm going to reply to your email very shortly, mate.
Okay, I think you just roll the one. So roll a d6.
Okay, I'm glad to hear it suddenly ducks. Glad to hear it, mate. Well, not just mate. 1d6.
Yeah.
All right. That's a 6, the boys!
That's the opposite of good.
Oh, so yeah,
you're wandering around, and there are wanted posters with your faces on them all over town. And the reward being offered for you is enough to maybe like set yourself up as a noble.
That's good in a way, right? I could hand myself in, win loads of gold, right?
Yes, yeah, so you could, like, basically, you could try and pay people off to, like, just not notice you and, like, have the local blue coat department just be like, eh, we've never seen these people before, how dare you? Or try to run and take even more heat that will continue to wreck you and put you under ridiculous scrutiny.
Why don't we just take the posters down?
That is a very good idea. Get Barry on it, and we'll unleash the rest of the hounds to go around the city to take down all of the posters. They can't put them up as quickly as we can take them down, am I right, or am I right?
Yes.
I'd love to say yes, but no.
But you're not right, will you?
Okay, so the other thing is you can try and de-stress by indulging your vices, recover things, or work on long-term projects, like, for instance, surgically amputating mysteriously growing extra limbs.
Well, I don't want to do that.
When you and Bay are one.
Maybe if you want to fit into society ever again.
To become one.
You can also buy shit for your gang or do something like that. I think we've only actually got 50 minutes left, so maybe it's just like, how do people go about chilling the fuck out and spending all your money post this nonsense?
Will just typed "we are one" in chat, and I just messaged him and said "we are one." Like,
oh shit, you did. Oh dear.
I hate it.
I hate it. Sums up this relationship. Right. Anyway. Okay, so what I do is I go and gamble away every single last dime that I've made.
Good, strong.
I spend some of it. Okay, I spend some of it. On like useful things, like upgrading the cockpit, as I call it, the
just your bedroom, I presume.
Yeah. Yes. It's just full of chickens now.
Okay. Yeah. So you go out and you gamble away, like probably like you enter a high roller's lounge for an evening and leave with no money left.
Yeah, pretty much.
You feel a lot better about yourself.
I feel really good though.
Yeah.
Because I've wasted everything.
York. Do you just buy an industrial shit ton of drugs?
I get an entire garbage bag full of black lotus flowers. I buy myself a little garage, probably underneath the cockpit.
I buy you some extra.
Just find you just in like the bar floor of the hideout, and there's just these flowers all over the floor. It looks like kind of a really romantic scene, and you're just rolling in them. Like, I'm literally like a sausage through all these drugs.
Carro is like super insensitive. He goes and buys some black lotus flowers and then he chucks them your way and says, "It's Remembrance Sunday, so I thought I ought to." And then like puts down the wreath of black lotus flowers for you.
It's like a daisy chain of basically like opium.
Yes.
Like death opium.
I'd just like to point out, I've still not got trousers since whatever happened. I've still got the same underwear.
I've just got so many drugs.
Coat. I probably went and got myself a fur coat because I was looking for one, I couldn't find it. And I've still got all the watches on and stuff, but I'm just in a dribbling mess.
Dressed like all this ridiculous jewelry, this horrifically like stained and gross shirt, no trousers, rolling in these flowers. It's like pupils the size of like your fucking head. Well, that's a thing.
Scarface, like, first you get the money, then you get the power, and that's it, just over and over.
Good. Finally, so Brenna, how is Brenna partying down?
I'm like drinking very heavily, like extremely heavy.
I like to think that there's it's so what's happening is that like Brenna is just sitting on a bar stool watching York do this. We see her just pour like a single measure of whiskey into a glass and then just starts chugging the whiskey bottle.
Yeah, the glass goes to my dog.
So yeah. The thimble.
Just like just fascinated.
And Barry takes it with his third hand. Like and like tips it down, but not into his mouth.
Barry, I've broken a self-loading dog.
My face is glowing.
Dear Lord.
We're praying.
I just feel like we should all jazz hands at the end of that.
I feel I should pray for forgiveness at some point along this. Yeah. I think on that, I'm going to have to think very carefully about the next time I run a game of this here for just... It's the worst. The worst thieves ever. It's like, why would we be ever stealthy? We could be just super obnoxiously loud. Like really obnoxiously loud. We could just blow up the like the safe and drop the safe down into the sewers and all that jazz. But no. We should summon a genocide whale. That seems like the way to do it.
Seemed to work out just fine.
Yeah.
I don't know why more people
nothing
don't
went
do
wrong.
It.
More people aren't just standing at the pier going, "Ooh, genocide whales!" Just like, "Hey, what's up? How you doing? How you living?"
I think Will needs more vodka. That's for sure. I'll get another glass.
Oh, that was the most slurred I've ever heard you speak. I think the session ends there because I don't think we can top this.
Well played, Fimba.
Thank you.
That was amazing, and thank you for walking us through it because I started off not knowing anything. It's a really nice system, actually.
It's got some good. I think there's a lot more depth to it than I've really gotten into. I just don't play enough of it, and there's like a lot of mechanics to connect things from place to place. But we're kind of doing weird things by doing one shots every month, so it doesn't feel natural to do all the crew upgrades and have this kind of little gang turf war. So we're kind of playing big strokes, Blades in the Dark. Which is a weird place to be. But fun.
I like it.
Yeah.
The next game we are playing in the 24-hour stream is The Tomb of Horrors. I am DMing this one, which is going to be fun and interesting. So
more weirdo eldritch horror for your viewing pleasure.
More weirdo eldritch horror, indeed. I do like your tweet, James Project. I do. I liked it so much that I actually clicked like. So, we've got another 18 hours to go. Something like 18 hours to go on 24-hour stream. So don't go anywhere. We're coming
24
back.
24 minus 6 is 18.
Correct, Finbar. Correct. It certainly is.
That's what having a math degree does for you people.
Wow.
Look at that.
So don't go anywhere. We're going to come back for our next game of Tomb of Horrors. I know Sydney is coming to play with me. I know From the Hollow is coming to play with me. And I know Foxhound is coming to play. And I think that might be all of us. I think that we've got 4 players, I think, yeah. So don't go anywhere. And yes, permission to fango excessively over Foxhound during Tomb of Horrors, because I'm going to be doing the same. And thank you to Ferret Dev for following. Welcome to the adventure, my friend. You are a gentle ferret and a scholar, so.
Scholar ferret would be a thing to see.
Indeed, yeah. So I'm going to... have to lovingly kick you guys with the warm boot
outrageous.
Of appreciation.
Oh, yeah, before I go.
Yeah, plugs shit.
Your
follow body.
My Twitter at FinbarDS, spelt like the one there, and then DS for more of my assorted nonsense ramblings. And
can I ask you why it's DS, or is it Finbar?
Because my full name is Finbar Dean Stott.
I know that. I have you on Facebook.
You,
I pay
you
attention.
Have me on Skype, where it's literally at the top of the chat.
Yeah. I pay attention to you. Don't worry.
Good. Yes. So yeah, that's why I'm on Twitter, because I can't even get my stream channel on Twitter, which is really annoying. And on Twitch, I am MathinTV, and this Tuesday I will be back here doing some space stuff.
Yeah.
We're going to space. We're going to become bounty hunters. I'm going to live on a big old spaceship. I've got this one, Will, joining me. He's going to be playing something that I'm pretty sure is a fan favorite around here or something. And also two people from my Snowocalypse stream.
Hello, everybody!
Stop!
Two people from the Mice Knockouts games, one of whom has literally designed a custom alien race. He sent me a briefing document with their, like, the social structure of their society and things like that in preparation for this. And yes, also a first-time role player and a good friend of mine, Dylan, better known on the YouTubes and the Twitches as the Conflict Nerd.
Hey,
a real cool guy. And yeah, you should come watch that.
Definitely do that. And I want to thank Gareth for coming along for extra time and filling in for us. Super helpful, mate.
Thank you, York, for your children's
Gareth,
presenter.
You're muted.
Yeah, sorry, my bad. Thanks for putting up with me, guys. That was brilliant.
That was good.
It was great fun. Don't worry about it, man.
I need to lay down.
Also, by the way, these are all the sheets of paper I have nowadays on this campaign, these games, because I've just got like 8 different characters noted down in like shorthand, and the nonsense I put up with for you people.
Yep. You do it for love.
Enjoy Tomb of Horrors.
Thank you.
And Weird Al's bullshit.
We will. I will.